into town to face the Texas Longhorns.
Hi, everyone. Bill Land and Gary Reasons aboard from Austin on a beautiful night for college football in a better-than-might-be-expected matchup, Gary. Texas rightfully so a heavy favorite. But these two played last year, and this Houston team is rebuilding quickly.
An 0-11 team last year. Dana Dimble has really got this team running, playing very well. They're 2-1 on this year. A year ago in the second quarter, they were ahead 14-10. He knows if they play well and don't make mistakes, they have a chance to hang in there.
When we last saw you, Texas thumped North Texas. Defense was great. Offense struggled at times. I think they got some of that taken care of with a big win at North Carolina last week.
Well, they made some changes up front with their offensive line. They moved Bo Baker in at guard. They moved Derek Dockery at the tackle. The production was very, very good. They got their offense running the football, which is what Mack Brown wants, balance. And they got Cedric Benson on target. He ran very, very well between the tackles. A big power runner. He got better as the game went on. Got over 200 yards rushing. That's excellent for the Longhorn offense.
You get Benson in that running game free, and then watch out with Sims and the plethora of receivers he's got. It's quite an offense.
Texas has the best skilled position players in the country, Bill, with Chris Sims at the helm, Cedric Benson running the football. Then you have Roy Williams outside catching the football, the big, strong target that he is, and the speed that Roy Williams has outside. There's a lot of weapons on offense with the Longhorns this year.
All right, you're an old defender, so let's go to that side of the football for the University of Houston. What do you do to try to slow down this attack?
Well, you've got to bring 8 or 9 people up to stop the run, so that means the cornerbacks have to play extremely well for the University of Houston. Victor Malone on one side and Cola on the other have to play very well. Man-to-man matchups outside on those receivers, and Hank Milligan, the free safety. He's a big guy, a big hitter. He leads the conference in tackles and the team in tackles. He needs to play well in the middle as well, also, Bill.
And as good as the Texas defense is, the Cougars feel they can get some points here tonight. They're excited about their youngsters, a freshman quarterback, Barrett Neely, and a pretty good-looking tailback in Joffrey Reynolds.
Barrett Neely's special. He's one of those run-type quarterbacks. He can run the ball and throw it, averaging 230 yards, 7 yards a game, total offense. And Joffrey Reynolds has 3 100-yard games under his belt this season. He's an excellent offensive weapon at the tailback spot.
All right, let's throw it down to the third member of our broadcast team, Jim Knox.
All right, thanks, Bill. Hey, perfect timing. Check this out. Here come the Longhorns right out of the tunnel. Here they come. And I tell you what, you guys talking about the explosive offense of the Texas Longhorns. How about that explosive defense? One of the best in the nation, and it starts right up there on that defensive line where you're talking big, powerful, fast, also looking to make big plays. You go with that All-American candidate, Corey Redding, one of the best in the business. Corey Redding, definitely a big game last week. 8 tackles against North Carolina, also had 8 quarterback pressures. And then how about the coming out party last year for that freshman linebacker, Derek Johnson? That's right. Derek had a big game against Houston, making plenty of tackles all over the field. And tonight he's expected to do the same. So the Houston Cougars offense, guys, very tough task going against that Longhorns defense, right? One of the best in the country, Bill.
All right, Jim, make sure you dodge Bevo and the crew down below. What fun tonight. It is Texas going against the Houston Cougars. We've got the kickoff straight ahead. Welcome back to Austin, Texas. University of Houston and the Texas Longhorns. Horns 2-0, ranked number 3 in the country, as the Cougs of Dana Dimble come to town at 2-1, his third year, 5-20, after 3 very successful years at Wyoming, where he was 23-12. He is putting some pretty good players on the field that are young and talented after an 0-11 year a year ago. And Mack Brown on the other side, his fifth year as a Longhorns head coach, 40-13, and Mack overall at 126-82-1 as a head coach, and did a great job at Carolina. And Richmond with the kickoff and the return by the Cougars. And that little wedge they put together at the 10-yard line did nothing to stop the Texas surge. And Houston will come out first at 10 from its inside the 10-yard line. Barrett Neely, the guy who can run and throw, very dangerous. The offensive line is anchored by 3-year starter Al Gaines. We told you about Reynolds. Watch out for Bell and Middleton in the receiving game as well. So as the Cougars come on, Neely out of Dallas, a redshirt freshman from Adamson High School, and it'll be first and 10 for the Cougs. Neely going to Robinson, and it is complete. Basically, a yard or two. Let's take a look at the Texas defense. With some changes because of injury. Stevie Lee slated to go for Tubbs, who was out with a concussion. And then the linebackers, Derek Johnson, has really gotten the Houston coach's eye with his great speed. Huff will come in at a corner. Vasher is going to take the night off. Griffin will move to fill his slot. Whether Griffin comes in and Huff moves over. Up the middle on a second down and 10 call. And not much doing there against that Texas front. See Griffin in on the play. Tim Feathers, the ball carrier, senior from Orange, Texas. Feathers, 6'2", 45.
Bill, you saw the first play of the ball game here for the Houston Cougars. They've got Barrett Mueller. Roll him out, get him out of the pocket. He runs well outside of the pocket. I tell you, that's something that the Longhorn defense had to practice for, and a good thing they had one of the quarterbacks on their team. They had Vincent Young, number 10, a young freshman. Very much a similar build to that quarterback and ran very well in practice. The Longhorns feel like they had a good look in practice against this Houston offense.
First down at 10. Neely got a nice block. And he can be dangerous when he gets the perimeter. He's run out of bounds near the 28-yard line. And pressure on the quarterback was Corey Redding. He's able to escape, but you see he's hobbling a bit.
A little ginger on, looks like a left leg or a knee, and going on the sideline. He's actually got his hands on the trainer there. Manny Dimble's going to make it. Actually taking Neely out of the ball game here.
Wow.
Going to be replaced. After the first time he's touched, that's a big blow to the Houston offense.
Let's take it down quickly to Jim Knox.
All right, thanks, Bill. You know, I talked to Dana Dimble, the Houston Cougars head coach, before the game. He said Barrett Neely got that knee banged up last week. He's playing with a sleeve on his left knee. Said it's a little sore. Looked like he took a pretty good shot right there, and he's out of the game. That's a huge blow for the Cougars.
All right, let's hope that he's able to come back. We'll see. As now, Nick Eddy will come on, a 6'4", 240-pound junior. He's from Cortland, California. And, boy, Houston comes in. Their game plan is centered around Neely. And everything changes now. Second down and 3 from the 29-yard line. Reynolds, a host of tacklers hit him near the line of scrimmage. Forward motion close to the 30-yard line. It'll be third and short.
Well, Bill, with Barrett Neely out of the lineup here, they were a 1-2 punch on offense with him at the quarterback position and Joffrey Reynolds in the tailback spot. You're going to see a lot more of Joffrey Reynolds tonight, though, I think, now with Barrett Neely out of the lineup. You see him there on a dime play inside. I would expect to get him to get the ball 30, 35 times tonight now.
Third and 2 from the 30-yard line, and the crowd gets into it. Another sellout house here at UT. Eddie. Incomplete, as covering was Roderick Babers and intended for Brandon Middleton. Middleton with 146 yards receiving to lead him in yardage. Eddie, that's just his fifth pass this year. He's played in 2 of the first 3 games.
Yeah, and he has to roll out to his left. A tough pass to get started on. Good coverage that time, though, by Babers, who had him make the throw outside and low and away from the receiver.
Well, youngsters, anytime those coaches give you, hey, you're one play away, all you got to do is think of what happened with Neely and Eddie here tonight in the first series for Houston. And Houston will kick it away with McCleary. Young, 25, looking for an edge. Finally goes forward to the 28-yard line. A flag is thrown.
Bill, I think that's Dakari Pearson actually returning punts tonight for the Longhorns. We've got Nathan Vasher, the nation's leading punt returner, out of the ball game. He's not suited up. He's on the sideline. He's not expected to play defensively or to return punts for the Longhorns.
Pearson, who last week had a couple of interceptions in the North Carolina game, will get the opportunity back there. Yeah, Vasher and Tubbs, we told you about, both were iffy until right before game time. The Mac Brown decided not to
illegal
go with
block,
to risk
block, in the back on the receiving team. 10-yard penalty. First down.
And I tell you, Dana Dimble's not too unhappy that he's not in there, because that's a tough guy to defend when he's returning punts.
Well, the University of Texas, they're calling him Chris Sensational, and he has been, with 5 TDs and no interceptions. Doan and Holloway are veteran anchors on the left side of the line. Benson, his first 200-yard game of the season last week. And you know about that trio of receivers they've got. First to 10 at the 19. Benson dragging a couple with him. And he brings it out to the 28-yard line. Let's take a look at how the Houston defense sets up. Clay Lane is a true freshman. Hill and Lee have played well. Braxton Davis and Woodard considered the backers. Milligan is a strong free safety that leads this team in tackles. Second and two for Texas. Benson. Malone finally puts a hit on him, but not until he gets to the 41-yard line as Benson is brought down there. Milligan also there.
Yeah, I tell you, Texas, they got back to basics last week. They're running now the ISO play. Going to have a fullback block out, and Cedric Benson able to come up inside. Watch the blocking at the line of the scrimmage. Make a big hole. The fullback reads and walls out. Cedric Benson gets in behind him. That's a core play. They ran it 35 times last week against North Carolina. Had a lot of production. That's a great play in their offense.
He picks up 14. It's first and 10 at the 41 for UT. Longhorns first possession. Sims hands it off. Why not? Benson. And Cedric Benson across midfield inside the 45 of the Cougars, where Hank Milligan made the tackle.
Well, when you're going to play here, you've got to play well the middle linebacker spot. 53 is not getting across. That's the middle linebacker, Justin Davis. He has to make that play. It's an ISO play. They have the fullback leading up on the linebacker. He has to make something happen. He's got to get to the line of scrimmage, or the Longhorns are going to run all over this Houston defense.
He picks up 15 on that carry. Davis in on the stop. Sims to throw it for the first time. And complete inside the 40. And wheeling down is Sloan Thomas to about the 36-yard line. Now, Sloan Thomas, just one reception that came in the UNT game, but Mac Brown said, don't worry, he'll get his, and maybe tonight will be the night.
No doubt. They have to respect his speed. He's a 4-4 guy. That little cushion there on the outside, and does a good job of coming back to the football, making a nice 9-yard gain for the Longhorns.
Thomas, second reception of the year, picks up 8, second and 2 at the 36-yard line. Texas rolling on its first possession. Benson cuts back left. And to the 35-yard line for Cedric Benson, the sophomore from Midland, Texas, out of Lee High School.
Watch the defensive surge here by the Houston Cougars. They do a good job of stacking things up. They've ran that play 4 times now. Benson goes back to the other side. Kay Lane, a freshman, makes a nice play inside the backfield, number 62, and then the rest of the Cougar defense comes to swarm Benson under.
Texas last week got 208 yards rushing from Benson on 31 carries. He was the Big 12 Offensive Player of the Week and helped lead Texas to the 52-21 win over Carolina. It's third and one from the 35. And Benson, another one.
Bill, as they pick up that first down, it's interesting about the Longhorns this year. They're one of the teams, one of the few teams in the country that have zero turnovers so far this year. That's impressive. When you have ball security, ball control, where you're not throwing interceptions, you're not putting the ball on the ground, you're going to have an opportunity to win. Conversely, the Cougars, they've had 12 turnovers on the year, and that was a problem for them in their second game against Tulane. They had 7 turnovers in that one football game.
They fell 34-13. That was sandwiched around a win over Louisiana Lafayette last week, as Benson again carries here. And they won their season opener in the Bayou Bucket game over Rice 24-10. Woodard makes the tackle on Benson this time.
Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator from Texas, told us this week, he said, well, he's going to take what the defense gives him. Basically, you're getting a 4-3 front here from the Cougars early on. Not going to do anything real crazy. They got to cover outside real well. They've got to adjust their secondary. They can't afford to put 8 and 9 guys in the box all the time. They have to cover these receivers. I think the Longhorns will pick their spots throwing the ball deep.
Second and 6 from the Cougar 28 for Texas. Benson. Boy, the offensive line is giving the kind of surge that they expected to get from this group and that we really didn't see ever in the North Texas game.
3 yards.
Third down and 3 with 9:30 to go, first period.
Well, we've seen this play 6 times tonight already. It's the ISO play. Tell you, the Cougars have to find a way to get into the backfield, get a little penetration, do something. Maybe the defense corner, Dick Bumpus, might decide to a little stunt inside, some kind of a run blitz early on in the downs to make something happen.
Third and three for the Texas Longhorns. Sims. Williams knows where that end zone is. Roy Williams with yet another touchdown. His 18th TD reception as a Longhorn, and that is the best in Texas history. Keeps adding to the records.
Boy, they made it look easy, Gary.
Well, there's two ways to look at this, either from a defensive perspective or an offensive. From an offensive perspective, it's an excellent effort and moves by Roy Williams. But on the defensive side, it's just exactly poor tackling. Those guys have to come up and make sure tackles on that receiver. Otherwise, Roy Williams will do that all night.
Dusty Mangum will come on for the point after. He's 10 of 10 this year. Mangum, sophomore from Mesquite, and he nails it. So Texas opening possession, impressive to say the least, as they go the length of the field, and Williams with a TD. A full Texas Memorial Stadium as the Longhorns with a 7-0 lead. Running got them down there, and then Sims to Roy Williams capped off the 81-yard drive in 9 plays. And it was like a clinic, Gary.
No doubt about it. They ran the ball very well, and they capped it off with the pass play. Take Roy Williams down here. Simple stop pattern. He's going to come back to the football. The defenders have to make better tackles and take better angles at him because Roy Williams is a strong receiver. See, one missed tackle, two there, and a third. Obviously, Roy Williams runs through all of those and into the house. These receivers here at the University of Texas are superlative. They are moving up the charts, Bill. All-time records here. You look at the numbers for Roy Williams, B.J. Johnson, Sloan Thomas. Look at the touchdown numbers for Roy Williams. Number one all-time here at the University of Texas. That's just tremendous.
And that was coming into this evening, so update them at home. Number 18 for Williams and 33 for the trio. Evans is deep with Middleton as Texas to kick it off. Richmond McGee. And the flag thrown. Let's go down quickly to Jim, get the update on the quarterback situation for Houston.
All right, thanks, Bill. Real quick, I was over at the University of Houston bench. Barrick Neely sitting on the bench. Mike O'Shea, the trainer, just massaging that left knee. Put a pad underneath the sleeve. He is coming back in the game. But, guys, one has to wonder, will he become a one-dimensional quarterback? You know, one of his best talents is scrambling, getting out of trouble. Does he now sit back in the pocket? Because if he gets hit on the knee, he's back on the bench.
Good point. You know, Gary, he's run for 187 yards in the first three games, and that's a big part of his action.
Well, I think they're going to do everything they wanted to coming in here this football game. I don't think they put Barrick Neely back in the football game if he couldn't run the full complement of the offense for the Cougars. Nick Eddy came in, did a nice job running two or three plays, but let's see what Barrick Neely can accomplish here coming back in.
First and 10 for Houston at the 35. Reynolds caught from behind by Corey Redding. Redding coming in with 12 tackles, 10 pressures of the quarterback. He has been every bit as good as they thought he would be coming into this season with all the preseason All-American honors thrown his way.
He may be the best defensive end in the country, takes on the lead block and then tracks down the line of scrimmage, the ball carrier. Corey Redding with the size. He came in as a linebacker, Bill, as a freshman, moved to the defensive line immediately, has been an impact player for 4 years, could be the number one defensive end in the country.
Brother Chris, a member of the Houston team, unable to play tonight because of an injury, so we don't get to see that matchup. Reynolds across the 40 to near the 42-yard line, and Redding again there to make the stop.
Now, that would have been a fun matchup. See, big Chris Redding is a 330-pounder, go against his brother who's, you know, 270 or so. They actually lined up on opposite sides of the field, but I might think that old Corey would say, hey, coach, put me on the other side. Let me go against him just for the old family's sake.
Third down and three is Neely. Off right out of the shotgun from the 42. High snap. Texas had it smothered. complete to Reynolds out of the backfield. That's his fifth reception of the year. But Lee Jackson, the strong side backer, led the way. Senior from Longview.
That's defensive speed. The Longhorns have it all across the board. Their linebackers in their secondary positions. If they can break up and make tackles like that. Watch here. As soon as he catches the ball, you've got a defender closing on him. That's Jackson, and Babers coming over the top. Excellent team speed for the Longhorns.
That'll bring on McCleary for the punting. His first one was a 50-yarder. And Pearson is again back for the University of Texas. McCleary, a 5'10 junior from Dayton, Texas. And Texas will again get good field position out of this, and Longhorns looking good at 7-0. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Second possession, Longhorns up 7-0. Sims throwing the touchdown pass of 25 yards to Roy Williams. Chris, with 6 TD tosses now in this, just the third game of the season. Bill Land, Gary Reasons, Jim Knox with you here in Austin. 6:50 to go, first period. And Texas first to 10 on its 40 after a 17-yard punt that time by McCleary. Benson stringing it out, looking for some room, and Houston pursuit this time as he is brought down by Lance Everson.
8 defenders around the line of scrimmage that time for the defense. The Cougars do a good job here bringing it up and forcing the run outside. Missed the block inside, didn't have the cut there. The fullback just could not make the kickout block. It was Hendrick Benson's trying to work to the outside. Pretty good team speed, though, by the Cougars as well.
Well, Texas has got some streaks going, including 14 straight at home on the plus side. Fifth longest among the nation's collegiate football teams. Longhorns last week with that road win, 9 straight on the road, and they've won 18 straight over non-conference opponents. And Houston in dire straits early here as Benson, right, left, up the middle, wherever he wants it. Malone and Woodard make the tackle this time.
One of the things we talked to the coach about a couple weeks ago, Bill, was the blocking of the wide receivers here for the Longhorns, and they've improved a lot about that. One of the things, they've caught the ball real well. They scored a lot of plays. They said for this offense to get on track, the wide receivers, they feel like, have to block a lot better. And when Cedric Benson breaks through that line of scrimmage, he's going to have a chance to make a big play if his wide receivers are blocking for him.
Third and 4 from the 46 of Texas. Sims complete across the 50. First down. Longhorns moving into Cougar territory as Brock Edwards, the junior from Fort Worth, the receiver, Victor Malone, makes the tackle. Not before Edwards gets his fourth reception of the year. He had a TD in that North Carolina win.
Well, they like to work the tight end into the pattern, get him out in there into space, and settles now, find the nice open area. Chris Simms delivers a nice ball. And it shows his strength and speed and power going against a smaller cornerback. Brock Edwards, good size here. 6'5", 250-pounder.
First and 10 at the 42. Simms resetting with a play. Play clock at 6. All day to throw it, and got one-on-one coverage. Oh, my goodness. Roy Williams, and watch out, pulling up lane.
That's not something Longhorn fans want to see.
Cola was the man beaten on the play. Williams holding the hamstring or the...
Wow, that is a... Oh. That could be a major, major setback for the Longhorns. One of the key players here for this offense, you'll see him, is going to be on the left side of your screen. Nobody's going to be in the way of Chris Simms. Unobstructed, he steps up and throws a nice, comfortable ball. Very well thrown. He's behind the defense. He actually should pull this ball in, but right at the last second, he slows his pace, and boy, obviously in pain with perhaps a hamstring injury. The ball is right there, and well, that's a ball that Roy Williams will catch 9 out of 10 times. Immediately grabbing for the lower part of the leg. That's the hamstring area. They're taking him directly right into the locker room, up the tunnel to Joe Jamail Field here. And
much closer than the bench area, so no reason not to. And, well, Jim will find out what we can. That is just a scary sight because he was just having a terrific season. He had ankle surgery to remove some bone spurs and is really, for the first time this year, healthy and just been phenomenal. It's 2nd and 10 at the 42. Benson and the whole crowd, Gary, whole atmosphere has changed. That this place became very quiet and people just buzzing about
Roy Williams.
Well, I'm sure a lot of conversations going on here, a lot of hush conversations, because he is a big piece of this offensive weaponry for the Longhorns. I tell you, Chris Sims has some other guys that he can throw to as well, and Tony Jeffrey, Sloan Thomas, B.J. Thomas, a lot of guys out there he can throw to, but I know he'd like to have Roy Williams as one of those main tools.
Third down and 10, the 42-yard line with 4:45 to go first period. Sims, no. Out in the slot on the dives, trying to get to the first down area. He's close, but I believe a little short where they're going to spot the football. Sims brought down by Damian West.
Well, the Cougars sell out to the coverage. Only rush three. Three guys are Chris Sims are going to step up inside, try to take off and get the first down for the Longhorns. He knows where he's got to get to. Tries to fake a throw and dive for it. Good job of closing by the Houston defense. Going to bring up a fourth and one.
So Sims gets him for a fourth and one at the 33-yard line.
Need to be able to do in tight ball games. They need to be able to power it out for one-yard gains.
Benson got the first down as he moves it down near the 31-yard line. Let's go down to Jim Knox with more on Roy Williams.
Bill, the news definitely doesn't look good. I was right here in the end zone when the play unfolded. It looked like that last ditch effort for Williams, that last burst of speed really what did that right hamstring in. As you saw, they took him right into the locker room, definitely grimacing and a great deal of pain. Big blow for the Longhorns offense.
No, not good at all. Well, we'll see how they respond as they come back here and get the first down. Benson goes in motion to the top of your screen now. Jeffrey also followed in that direction. And nothing doing here with a loss on the play for Tony Jeffrey as Woodard makes the tackle, the weak safety. Jeffrey, a sophomore from Houston out of Klein Forest High School.
Well, the Houston defense is showing they can play here. They can play line sideways here. Gives his Longhorn offense. Yeah, they may be a little susceptible inside pounding the football. The Longhorns are spreading it out, though. And going with an ISO play early on here, deciding to spread it out. Three receivers in the game now.
Second and 12 from the 33 for Texas. Benson resets. Sims to throw and complete. At the 25-yard line. And Tola and Woodard there make the tackle. Shanahan, the receiver.
Kyle Shanahan, a senior. He's 6'3", 185 pounds. Comes back for the football, doing a nice job. Coaches told us he would probably play this week. He's played very well in practice. And although Roy Williams is out of the game, I'm sure with him out of the game, he's probably going to need a lot more reps.
Shanahan's first reception of the season has been banged up a little bit. Good to see him back on. And it's third and three. Sims, incomplete. Edwards was crossing. And Cola was in the face of Sims, pressuring him.
I don't know if there's miscommunication. It looked like the tight end almost stopped on the route going out there. Chris led him a little bit. A little juice on that ball, though.
Well, one of the highlights for Texas this year has been Sims has been red hot early. What, he hit his first 9 or 10 in the UNT game. They scored on 4 of the first 5 possessions against North Carolina. And a chance to score on their first 2 here. The touchdown to Williams to start the game. And now a 41, let's see, on the field goal attempt, Dusty Mangum. Mangum, 3 of 5 this year, 27. And right up the middle, touchdown! They do score, but not quite the way we expected it. As the Longhorns get the TD, and
that's Bo Trahan for the Longhorns, Bill.
Mr. Special Team, 2 outs.
He does it all.
Bo Trahan.
He covers kicks. He covers punts. He blocks. He does everything they ask him to. He's the holder on the field goal team. It takes the direct snap right up the middle. Excellent job by the Longhorns up front. Give him a hole to run through. That's a special play for that young man. Take a look here. He just picks it up and goes. And in college football, the snapper can have his knee down legally and then pick it up and go and make a move from there. And Trahan puts another touchdown on the board for the Longhorns.
Graham from Bay City, Texas, gets the touchdown, and Texas on the board again with a 24-yard TD run from Trahan. You know he's grinning from ear to ear. The point after goodbye, Mangum, 14-0 Longhorns. It's a penalty and a 10-yarder. They're going to re-kick the point after. Welcome back. And Mangum takes care of this one. Kind of gives him a little bit of experience for the field goal attempt if he needs it a little bit later on. And it is indeed 14-0. Welcome back to Austin. Bill and Gary Reasons and Jim Knox with you. Another look here at the fake field goal and the run by Trahan.
Watch the sellout there. And oh, my goodness, he doesn't have the ball, doesn't kick it. Oh, Trahan does a nice job picking his way through there. That's a special play for a team's unit. I tell you, that echoes throughout the team because guys who play on special teams, they make up your offense, your defense. Some of those guys are just special teams designees, which Bo Trahan is. That's a great play for that football team and that, especially for that young man.
Well, Trahan, we mentioned in the opener with North Texas, made seemingly every special teams tackle. It wasn't the case, but he was in on about every play. And here he shows that, yeah, I can find the end zone too.
All right, let's just put a camera on him. Let's see what Bo Trahan does on his kickoff. Wouldn't be surprised if he's down there in the mix and making a hit on the return.
So Texas scoring on its first two possessions tonight. If you turned away for a moment, there is some bad news, and that was Roy Williams went off holding his hamstring. We'll let you know more as soon as we know that. Houston also lost Neely on the first series. He has since returned. Texas to kick it away. Richmond McGee. And it's taken by Middleton. The 10, the 20, and Middleton. Good surge before he is brought down, stopped at the 24. I think it'll be the forward progress point, and that's where the Cougars will take over again.
Any chance that Trahan's in on that tackle on the kick? Let's take a look at what Trahan does. He's the number four guy on the outside. He is outside contained. He's in his lane. A little hold there. He's just being feisty there. The ball's not in his way, but that's just what happens when you're out there covering kicks. You have to get rid of those blockers. Get in there on the action.
And you've really got to love special teams to be a good special teams player, do you not?
You have to have a passion for it. You know, and it's really special because when you do something there, you know that you're not out there all the time, but the few times you're out there and you make a big play for your team, so it echoes and it makes a real statement.
Reynolds carrying the football on the first and 10 for the 24, brought down by Derek Johnson, sophomore from Waco. Reynolds been over the 100-yard mark in each game this season. He came in with 74 carries for 412, 5.6 per carry.
This Longhorn defense doesn't give up 100 yards rushing to many running backs. It's been quite a while since that's happened against this defense. A year ago, Bill, this defense was ranked number one in the country overall in total defense. This year, they're 15th overall and making strides in the run game and the passing game.
Reynolds tripped up here. Reynolds last year, 15 carries for 56 yards against Texas, and that was a game the Longhorns won down in Houston. All well aware of the bleachers that were erected and then considered unsafe and taken down, and Texas fans left with a bad taste as they were unable to see the game, many of the fans. And this is the end of the series as we know it. Texas leads at 15-7-2. They've won the last six. Last year, 53-26, the win in Houston. Well, third down from the 26, third and 8. Nearly intercepted as Neely never saw Michael Huff. And Huff had six if he'd have held on.
Major communication problem between Brian Robinson up here on the top. He goes inside. Huff's going to stay to the outside and boop, oops. Almost an interception for a touchdown. Wow.
Huff, the redshirt freshman from Irving out of Nimitz High School, as Dana Dimmel looks on.
Pearson back for Texas.
Pearson.
Well, this is
deep
something
Texas.
This is something special teams-wise they were looking at doing to negate Nathan Vasher, move their punt team coverage unit around to make the Longhorns adjust to their coverage.
Yeah, they anticipated seeing Vasher, who was out with the injury, although Pearson can be dangerous as well. But what's happened is they had a 25-yard punt this time, 17 last time, and that was not the plan for Dana Dimble.
Yeah, he gave him too much hang time there on those punts. He had to drive the ball a little bit more. Dana Dimble, he knew that when he came in here to this football game, if they were going to be successful, at least have a chance to compete, they have to do two things. They have to be real secure on making ball security and play smart football. If they don't make turnovers, and if they play smart, they'll have a chance to compete with this team. They realize there are some tremendous athletes at the University of Texas. They may match up in some spots, but some spots they really don't. They understand that. But it's a game, if they compete well, he hopes that good things will happen for them.
Sims, first and 10 from his own 48-yard line. And complete, couple of yards to midfield. Benson on the receiving end. Cedric, five receptions coming in here tonight for 30 yards. That ends the first period. An impressive Texas start. The Longhorns lead it 14-0 over the Houston Cougars. Back for the second quarter in a moment.
Daryl K. Roll, Texas Memorial Stadium. Yes, they're getting in the Longhorn spirit here. A couple of girls from the Texas women's basketball team, Stacy Stevens, also Anissa Hastings. You guys, all of a sudden, look out, ranked in every publication in the top 10 in the nation. Excited to tip that season off, I'm sure, huh?
Yeah, it's very exciting. It's a great experience for us. We work really hard this summer, work really hard during the season, and it's just good for us to be ranked in all the polls. We just have to come out and prove it that we're ranked right there.
How about this guy, Stacy Stevens, right here to the right of me, played on the women's U.S. national team in Brazil. And what'd you guys do over in Brazil, Stacy?
We won a gold medal. Heather Schreiber.
That's it, just a gold medal?
Yeah, we just won a gold medal. Heather Schreiber was on the team, too. She's here, plays here at UT. I mean, this team this year, man, we're just stacked. I mean, it's amazing. We're gonna prove to some people how good we are this year, that's for sure.
There we go. Congratulations on the gold medal. Good luck on the upcoming season. Let's get some more Hook'em Horns going, huh?
Everybody come to the games.
Yeah, there we go, Bill.
Two outstanding players, and they are going to have a heck of a team, Stacy Stevens and Anissa Hastings. Meanwhile, back on the football field, Texas will have a 3rd and 4 at the 46. You see Benson's totals so far. It's a guy that is a workhorse. The more carries, the better he gets. At the 46 of Houston, Sims, complete. Thomas, nice spin as he used the hand to keep his balance. Got the first down at the 37-yard line. Everson was there covering.
Just good job of pushing off here by Thomas on the outside. Chris Sims just delivers a strike, and watch the quickness here by Sloan Thomas. Stop and start. He might be the most athletic of the three receivers here, the big three at the University of Texas. Like what he can do with the football after he catches the ball. Had a couple of drops early on, but I think he's got that all behind him early in the season, and off to a pretty good start tonight.
Well, one of the things you like as these receivers get older is they don't get, not that they were overly concerned about numbers, but they're more concerned about winning now. They all know they're going to get their time and get their share of balls. Here's Sims on 1st and 10. Incomplete, nearly intercepted. Intended for Tony Jeffrey, and covering was Victor Malone, and Malone wishes he had another shot at that. Senior from Brooksville, Mississippi, out of East Mississippi Junior College.
Well, watch Sloan Thomas come all the way across the field. I actually think Chris Sims is trying to throw it to Sloan Thomas, but Tony Jeffrey brings it all the way back, and you're going to see his defender come into the picture. I think Chris overthrew Sloan Thomas on the play.
And Sims, fortunate there, no interceptions so far this year. 2nd down and 10 at the 37. Texas with a 14-0 lead, early moment, second period. Benson, boy, nice move, and it powers ahead to the 30-yard line. Benson picking up 7 before he's hauled down by Milligan and Everson.
Offensive line coming off and showing that they can block very, very well. Take a look here at the top of the screen. 76, Derek Dockery is closing off the inside, and then Cedric Benson doing what he does best. That's shake and bake a little bit, move to the outside, and run through tacklers. There was a penalty bill at the play, and the referees are sorted out.
Offside. Defense. 5-yard penalty. Repeat 2nd down.
Thank you, Steve. 13:43 remaining here in the first half as Mac Brown has got to like what he sees from his football team so far.
Offensively, they're hitting it on stride. They're running the football well. Chris Sims. I tell you, they're throwing the ball. You see the total numbers here for both teams, and Texas just ringing them up.
Last week, Texas, 569 yards of total offense. Matt Brown says, boy, I love those 500-yard days. Here is Benson. And close to the first down, Lee making the tackle. Adrian on a long view, Texas.
Cedric Benson got the football that time, Bill. Coming to the line of scrimmage, hey, he had three or four options to go with, right, left, up, to, or straight up. And the offensive line doing a good job here, giving him the space here. Look inside where he has a chance to pick his spots. There's enough space there. He's not having a small crease where he has to get through and get there quick. He's got enough time to make a decision and make good positive yards.
Benson impressive tonight. 13 carries, 64 yards. Third and one. Sims with the keeper. You know, and there's the other nice thing about having a quarterback at 6'5", 225 who can pick those up for you in a minute.
Well, obviously that's good. One of your offensive line can block these guys in the trenches do well. You got Derek Dockery and Bo Baker on the right side. A little protection here for their quarterback. They're doing a nice job there. Here they are pulling around Bo Baker, cleaning up.
And the whole
Derek Dockery on the right side. That was the change they made a week ago. You see him here closing it off inside for Cedric Benson to get out to the outside. I think Matt Brown is very pleased and probably settle on that right side right now.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line. Texas moving again with a 14-0 lead. Benson trying to stiff arm his way around the near side. Brought down by Justin Davis, a 6'2", 226-pound junior. Houston North Shore.
Yeah, from North Shore High School around the Houston area. Good job that time by the young linebacker. Just slide to the outside, playing downhill, making a good tackle on a good running back.
Davis had six tackles in the game last year. Houston 2-1 coming in. As I mentioned, a win over Ulala, 36-17. And they held the Cajuns just 78 yards rushing in that game. Tonight, Texas is running it, powering it right down their throat. Second and eight for the 24. Sims to throw. Incomplete. Well, it picked off as it juggled and then was taken away. This is Victor Malone. Malone with Sims there to upend it. Thought it fell to the ground, but Malone was there before, and Malone with his first interception of the season.
Chris Sims throws a strike here to his outside receiver, Tony Jeffrey, and it's going to come off his shoulder pad. Watch Jeffrey come down inside, and Sims is going to hit him on the shoulder pad. He breaks away. Bingo, it's up. Good job that time by Malone. He's probably down. I thought his knee was on the ground. Watch an athlete, though. Chris Sims, the quarterback, come out of nowhere, takes a proper angle. He's 6'5", 230 pounds. Hey, he can run as well and make a good play in the open field.
Yeah, and didn't do anything stupid. Got in his way enough to make the tackle, not get hurt. And now the Texas crowd comes alive as Houston following the turnover. First and 10 on the Longhorn 29. If Houston's going to have a shot at making this game competitive, they need to pick up points in these situations.
Well, take things. Opportunity knocks. You have to make the most of it. The Cougars want to do that. They're down here, a chance to score. That was the very first turnover for the Cougars, for the Longhorns this entire season. That was a ball that was tipped and went up. It really wasn't Chris Sims' fault. But, you know, I'll tell you what, they've had a couple of balls in their hands that Chris Sims has thrown, and they could have made interceptions. That was one they actually picked up on.
Reynolds, the ball carry. He picked up seven, second and three at the 22. Again, Reynolds fighting to the 20-yard line. Let's go back down quickly to Jim Knox.
Hey, guys, just keep in mind, ever since Barrick Neely took that hit on his knee, what has happened is he's just been continuing to hand the ball off. Nothing's really been happening, him running out of the pocket or anything like that, that has taken that dimension of him being able to explode out of the pocket. That has basically put him into a handoff quarterback and a quarterback that just sits back there in the pocket.
Third one, let's see what he comes up with here. Neely keeps. He would appear to have it. They may have to measure. We'll see as they...
They had to get all the way to the 19-yard line. It's going to be interesting where they spot the ball. The line judge here on the near side is probably a little bit short of that. I don't know which one of the officials is going to put the ball down on the ground, though. That's a good point, though, that Jim Knox made. Obviously, Barrick Neely not wanting to run around on that knee. Perhaps the quarterback coach is feeling like that he should not run around on that simply because not really sure how well he's going to hold up. They don't want him to get banged around that back there. And they feel like if he's in the ball game, they have the most confidence in him. But that dual threat of being able to throw the ball and run the ball is what Barrett Neely brings to the table. And he right now, he's just one-dimensional.
There you see what is needed for a first down on an upcoming third down for Dama Dimmel and the Cougs.
And I think it's going to be a fourth down.
Fourth down, bigger part, yeah.
Yeah, we're going to go for it here on fourth down. Dama Dimmel's leading his troops out there. Hey, what the heck? You come in here, the Longhorns are ranked third in the nation. Let's see if you can get one on fourth and short.
Hogan, he needs touchdowns, not field goals, if they're going to win this game. And they may have got Texas to jump. Now that's the other part of it.
I think we're going to have a false start on the top of this field. We've got a tight end that jumped on the top of the page. I think Matt Maddox on the top, the tight end, actually was a false start for the Cougars.
Yep.
Dead ball. False start. Offense. 5-yard penalty.
So now we'll see if he brings Dustin Bell on, the sophomore kicker.
Take a look right there. Matt Maddox, actually the left guard, started first, and then he kicked in the same time. So Rex Hadnott kind of got a little early start there, his left guard spot, the tight end as well. So we try a field goal, and hey, this is not bad too. You get some points on the board, not going to be the fourth down and one conversion that you wanted to have, but here's an opportunity with a 42-yard field goal to at least get 3 points up there.
Dustin Bell out of Jersey Village High School, 6 of 6 on the year. His longest, a 44. Gary mentioned this, a 42-yard field goal with a left footer. Line drived it and nailed it.
Off the post on the right side, Bill. Kind of a helicopter went through the post. So good job there converting.
But Texas Tech would have done for one of those today against NC State. We'll be back, 14-3 Texas. Dimmel and the Cougars are on the board. 14-3 on the field goal as Dimmel brings Houston in here tonight.
Well, 3 points on the board, Bill, for that man and his football team. And really enjoyed meeting with him this week. I think he's got the program for the Houston Cougars on the right track. It's a building process. He knows that. He's done a very good job of recruiting the state of Texas. And you know, he applauds his coaches and what they've done to go out and recruit. They've got a good rapport now with the high school coaches in the state of Texas. There's a tremendous amount of football players from just the Houston area alone that he knows that could come in there and play for him. And Danny Dimmel's recruiting the Houston area very hard. He's got about 35 guys on their team right now that are just in the Houston area alone.
Yeah, much the way Mac Brown has come in and established himself with the high school coaches and the strength in recruiting there, Dimmel's doing a similar thing at the University of Houston. The kickoff by Bell and goes out of the end zone as Texas will let it roll over the head that time of Harris, I believe. So Bell will go off and take a look. There's the recruiting that's been going on from Houston for these teams. For the Cougars, 31 Houston area players, Longhorns with 19.
A lot of good football players in the Houston area, Bill.
Well, and it was kind of interesting. Houston, kind of everybody lives in the shadow of the coaches there of Bill Yeoman, really, who was there for 25 years. And even though there's been some success after him, it's no different than Daryl Royal's shadow here that every coach has had to follow in.
Chris Sims checking off the line of scrimmage.
And Sims, plenty of time out, and he's finally sacked. Give that as a coverage sack as the line held him out for quite a while there and finally brought down on the 11-yard line.
Well, he had plenty of time. He's just actually waiting for one of his receivers to go out. Just a two-man route that time. Pretty simple execution, he called it. Just couldn't get anybody open downfield. And I tell you, after a while, those guys are going to rush and get to you. Good job of time to continue on the rush.
Farouk Adelkin with the tackle that time for the University of Houston.
That's his fourth sack of the season, Bill.
Yeah.
Young freshman doing a good job for him. And they knew they'd give him a little push to come up in the line of scrimmage. And did a good job getting the backfield for him.
So it's second down and 19. Sims in trouble. Shovel pass. Benson. He is hauled down quickly there. Ryan Huffman, junior from Orlando, Florida, makes the tackle.
I'm not sure Chris Sims wants to call this play again. Watch number 92, Adrian Lee, on the top here. He's going to bang Chris Sims after the shovel pass. Bingo. That's a form tackle. Good job that time by the Cougars. Conversion on Cedric Benson. Didn't allow the shovel play to get started.
Lee made the pressure and then the tackle by Huffman. And Texas now with a third down and 18 from its own 12. Need to reach the 30 for the first down. Sims Complete the 20, 25, going to be shy of the first down as catching the football, Brett Robin, junior from Austin Westlake.
25. Yeah, Brett Robin, the third down back here for the Longhorns, coming in, getting pretty good real estate, allowing the Longhorns a chance to punt. A little more real estate behind him. Chris Sims just reads down the field and comes down to Robin, who just circles around from his backfield spot. Nobody rushing, so he's allowed to get out in the pattern, and he's a check down, and just a couple of yards short here. It brings up fourth and three.
Does give Brian Bradford a little breathing room kicking-wise, even though they don't get the first down. Line of scrimmage, the 27-yard line. And Bradford, who's been averaging 39-plus, gets off a dandy here. Bell tackled and flags are thrown. He may not have given him enough room. As Unger coming in on the tackle, he's another one of those special teams gunners.
I do not like this rule. There's no doubt about it. This is bringing college football back a lot of steps back. Young man does a nice job of covering the kick here. He breaks down, which is the concept of the rule. Watch him break down before he gets there. He stops, breaks down. The ball is there. You need 2 yards to a halo rule. I think that is crazy.
On the kicking team, 10-yard penalty.
Yeah, it's not fair to the officials either. It is so difficult to call. That was a great example of how hard it is. We'll be right back. Beautiful night for football. Texas supporting a 14-3 lead here at Darrell K. Royal Texas Memorial Stadium. One of the things that Texas is trying to get more of this year are big plays, because those are the ones that turn a game over. Here's a pretty interesting graphic of Mac's winning measure.
Well, obviously, when Mac Brown talked to us, he said over the past 30 years of him coaching, he measured these plays here. You got 16 yards better passing or 12 yards running, and he keeps a total of those, and we're going to keep up with those tonight. You see that Houston has no big plays in Texas, 3, and the one turnover, though, this actually should go over here. That's a big play, though, for Houston, obviously, with the interception, running back, putting the field goal on the board.
Texas with its 2 touchdowns, both being big plays. Reynolds stopped at the 35-yard line. And Texas getting the 24-yard, or the 25-yard TD pass to Roy Williams, the 24-yard touchdown run by Bo Trahan on the fake field goal.
More to that point about the explosive plays, Bill. Over time, if you look at those numbers, Mac Brown really feels like those are a telltale story for his football team and how well his team is going to do. You can run the ball, big plays there. You pass the ball, big plays. Those things win football games.
Officials stop play here again as timeout is called. Be charged to the University of Houston. With the Cougars trailing 14-3. Bell's 42-yard field goal getting their 3 points. And so far, Neely really has not been a factor here. And certainly Texas was concerned about controlling Neely, but he's playing, I think, a little timid, as Jim mentioned.
Well, he did run to the sideline that one time. He got dinged on the knee and obviously hasn't played like that, not as reckless. Hey, the one of the things that Dana Dimble talked to us about is he had to teach that young quarterback when he rolls out of the pocket to make the right decisions of throwing the football or running the football, and really hasn't had a lot of opportunities tonight, but that's one of the things he likes for him to work on.
Yeah, he was saying, I don't expect him to be a leader. I want him to make plays and bring him along slowly. Let's go back down to Jim Knox.
All right, thanks, Bill. Just want to update everybody on the situation. Roy Williams, we just got word they continue to evaluate the hamstring in the locker room. As soon as we get word on how significant as far as the severity of this hamstring injury is, we'll pass it on to you. But right now, Roy Williams continues to be in the Longhorns locker room.
Also missing from this club is Nathan Vasher this week. He's not even suited up for this football game. A cornerback and punt returner, a real cog there for this football team. And also Marcus Tubbs, a defensive tackle up front, that they're going to count on quite a bit this season.
There's Vasher. Not even give him a chance to be out there. Second and 11. And Reynolds, whether...
That was Barrett Neely.
Neely kept it himself as Johnson made the tackle.
Well, that was a play that the Longhorns had trouble with last week. Darian Durant from North Carolina did a good job with the quarterback's draw. Ran them very well inside and outside. I think the Longhorns practiced that just a little bit this week. Vincent Young running around, and I wonder how many times he actually got hit.
Well, Texas has been running a little bit of a 3-3 alignment in passing situations, and some folks figure that is the weak area. Well, it's 3rd and 7. Let's see what they do here. Neely, incomplete and nearly picked off, and he got hit in the backfield as well. Griffin was covering on the play defensively.
Well, you've got a three-man line here. You're going to rush three. A little twist here by the linebackers coming inside. Going to force a little pressure inside. The quarterback's going to deliver right there. I'll tell you, not a good throw. The receiver wasn't even looking for the football and looking for him to do a wheel out, but he just continues across the field.
McCleary to kick it away as Pearson stands back for the University of Texas inside the 25. Pearson, fair catch, and at the 16-yard line is where Texas will get possession. Stay with us here. It is 14-3 Longhorns. Well, Texas certainly has established the run tonight as they did against North Carolina. It's something Mack Brown has been pushing here in this early part of the season. We had a chance to find out more about that.
We averaged 250 yards a game rushing with Ricky our first year and 250 yards a game passing. That's what we want. I've told our coaches I like that. I like the perfect balance, and I'd like 500 yards a game and 40 points a game, so that's easy. Since then, we've thrown the ball effectively. We haven't run it as effectively. At times last year with Cedric, we ran the ball really well, but we didn't do it every week. We'd like to be a team that can line up and run the ball every week and throw the play action pass and not put pressure on one player to have the good day.
Well, they're averaging 149 on the ground. They have a problem with the clock is why the game is being held up here. The north end zone is the game clock with 6:07 to go here in the half. The Texas 149 rushing average thanks to the big effort last week. Benson 66 yards, Trahan 24, the big carriers tonight here in this first half. And here's Benson again.
Mack Brown's not too tough on himself and his coaches. 250 yards rushing, 250 yards passing, 500 total yards. Hey, that's a great day.
He's just ordering it up, isn't he?
He's just dialing it in. It's not easy to come by, and I'm sure he knows that very well, but I think he's established a running game here with Cedric Benson. I think that Greg Davis has decided that Cedric Benson is going to be his first and second down back. Robin comes in on third down, does a nice job. He did that all last year, and Cedric Benson running between the tackles. He's got power. He's got speed. He's elusive. Hey, he's the complete back.
15 carries, 73 yards now on a second down and three. And Sims completes it for the first down and out across the 34-yard line as Milligan makes the tackle on Shanahan. Shanahan's second reception of the night.
Chris Sims, little play action passer, little bootleg, little fake in the backside. Got everybody coming across the field. He's got two levels in front of him. Good job picking out Shanahan coming across.
And Texas first and 10 now at the 35. Benson. Not much doing this time on the first and 10. Brought down by Everson, linebacker for the University of Houston.
One thing about Chris Sims throwing the football, Bill, I think he's a very accurate passer. He throws the ball real well. He makes good decisions. Obviously, when you have a talented quarterback that can do that, he's a senior, he's seasoned, he's ready to go. I've heard comments from him throughout the preseason here that, hey, he knows they've got good football players here. They know they expect a lot of them, a lot of good things. He's taken upon himself to not make mistakes and play within the context of the offensive system.
Number five in career passing yardage. You saw those totals there. Tipped away and nearly picked off by Malone again. Davis was in on the pressure there.
And Justin Davis, the linebacker, slides to the outside. Just getting a pass drop and gets in the throwing lane. Chris Sims trying to slip one through there. Good job that time by Justin Davis, the linebacker, knocking it away.
Well, Mack Brown will tell you the other thing Chris got going for him this year is there's no talk about even who's starting anymore, who's playing, or that it's nothing but the team. And he said that's made all the difference in the world, that he is the guy. There's no question about it, and he has certainly settled into it nicely. Third and 10. 35. Sims steps up here and nearly picked off, but caught. It'll be a first down at the 49-yard line. And a flag is thrown as Thomas of the Jeffrey. And Malone makes the tackle.
That's Robert Timmons, I believe.
Timmons, a freshman.
Good protection here. Sims sticks it in there. Watch the contact here. He goes through and contact behind Robert Timmons. Grabbed it.
Defense. 15-yard penalty. From the end of the run. First down.
Robert Timmons is a freshman from Flower Mound Marcus, who is a sensational athlete and really caught the attention of the Texas coaches in the preseason scrimmages, then had a bit of an injury that set him back, but he shows you a little bit of his athleticism and fight for the football on that play.
Now, any receiver that'll go across the middle, go up for it in traffic and come down with a good grab, I tell you, that turns a lot of coaches' heads, and they're gonna see that.
Back to pass Sims again, and it is complete at the 25. And this is Sloan Thomas as he scoots down to the 23-yard line before Jesse Sowles makes the tackle.
Sloan Thomas, one of these three receivers from Klein High School and down near Houston, does a nice job here. He's very athletic, just scoots right over the cornerback and does a nice job of getting down the field. Victor Malone had him in coverage out there, but Sloan Thomas showed that he can catch a football and run with it after the catch. He's done that pretty well tonight.
Sowells, I beg your pardon on that pronunciation. Jesse Sowells makes the tackle out of Willow Ridge from Houston area. First and 10, ball at the 24. Texas powering forward with that line. Benson down to the 20-yard line.
I was talking with the sports information director before the game, John Bianco here from Texas. Talking about Sloan Thomas, the fact that Sloan had really caught just one football and had a few drops. And he said, hey, it's any time these guys can break out. And he's caught three balls here tonight, so there's a lot of receivers, a lot of weapons here. Obviously, with Roy Williams out of the ballgame now, looking possibly with a hamstring, there will be more pressure put on he and B.J. Johnson and Jeffries also to make plays.
Second down and six at the 20 for the Longhorns, up 14-3, 3:20 to go in the half. Benson, watch out! Down to the 6-yard line. Pickup of 14 for Cedric Benson, and Hannick Milligan makes the tackle.
Well, Tillman Holloway, number 61, just going to clear everything out right there. And Cedric Benson, he's going to chip on the linebacker too, do a good job, get two blocks on the same play. Cedric Benson gets through there all the way back to Milligan, who has to make the tackle to save it for a touchdown.
Well, talk about Matt Brown wanting 500 yards and half and half. Not much better than that. 115 to 119, and Benson now with 91 yards. First to goal from the six. Still going. Powers his way, made a nice run just to pick up a yard. Marking around the 5-yard line, and Sowells made the tackle for Houston.
Now, these are tough yards down here. This Houston defense is shoring it up. They're bringing more people to the line of scrimmage, getting inside. Tell you, a really physical play out there.
Listen in, you'll find out what it means. First to goal from the six. Still going. Powers his way. Made a nice second and goal from the 5-yard line for the Longhorns. Benson, did he get it over? As Benson leaning forward, trying to break the plane with the football. And Sowells again making the tackle.
Sowells again on the tackle.
But Benson, three touchdowns coming in here tonight. Look at the eyes.
Well, he sees daylight here. He wants to get through that hole. He reaches and stretches out. Good call. The leg is down, the knee is down before he gets to the end line. He brings up here a third and one at the goal line.
Cedric, 12 touchdowns a year ago in his first year here at Austin. Benson, no stopping him this time. Rolls in from the one, and Texas makes it 20-3. Cedric Benson, his fourth touchdown of the year. He had two against North Carolina, one against UNT. And talk about consistency, 97 yards rushing in the first half.
I tell you, pretty good effort by that young man. A lot of people a year ago were really upset with Matt Brown for not playing him consistently, playing him every single down. Hey, 21 carries tonight for 97 yards. Cedric Benson shows that he is a workhorse and doing a good job for the Longhorns.
And the point after is good by Mangum. And that makes it 21-3. No flags this time. And take another look at Benson and this Texas drive as the Longhorns soar behind that offensive line.
Well, whenever you get blocking up front, good things happen. You see Sims throwing the football, and then Cedric mentioned the benefits of the running game.
Texas
on the left side, you've got Tillman Holloway, Robbie Doan, and
then
Jason Glenn in the middle
Benson,
of the center, opening up holes for Cedric Benson. When you can have that kind of a hole for this kind of a talented back, he's going to make a lot of yards. He's got 97 here midway through this, or towards the end of the second quarter.
So Benson caps off the 84-yard drive that took 4 minutes and 25 seconds, and the Longhorns make it 21-3. Texas averaging 39.5 points per game and well on their way to meeting that mark here tonight. Fans having fun here at the stadium. Mac Brown is one of the things he stressed. He said, you know, what is it? The only big games are the ones you lose, according to the Texas fans. He said, I just wish people would appreciate, enjoy the ride a little bit and enjoy every game for what it is. And this is a great scene. It's what college football is really about. And he said, you know, we certainly can only take them one at a time. I kind of wish the fans would do that too.
Well, a lot of fans are just seeing the big picture. Hey, they want what's ultimately at the end of the rainbow to come early. But you can't do that. You have to play a game one at a time. You have to, the most important game, I was talking to my son about this today. I said, hey, what's the most important game? He's a high school football player. It's not the one that's 3 or 4 down the road. It's the next game, and it's the same in the college game as well.
Texas with a kickoff, and the hard hit at the 20-yard line. Let's go down to Jim Knox real quick.
Okay, real quick, Bill. Roy Williams, as you see, in street clothes, had a few words with Chris Sims. Of course, he's through for the night, but it looks like the right hamstring. When we get word, we'll pass it on to you. But Roy Williams, definitely through for the night. Still looks like he's in pretty good spirits despite the injury.
Thank you, Jim. That big hit was put on Middleton as Texas will have Houston operate at the 1st and 10 at the 20-yard line. Braden Johnson with a big hit there for Texas on Middleton on the special teams. 1st and 10. Neely in trouble and escapes one man. Comes back, has got some blockers now. Neely trying to utilize them. And runs out of bounds near the 27-28-yard line where Reed Boyd was there from New Braunfels, Texas, 6'3", 235.
Well, he looked like he's running pretty good, but not as well as I've seen him play before. That knee is obviously bothering him. If he was be at full strength, he'd be a little more competitive, I think, running the football, taking a little more chances. But right now, he settled in behind his offensive line as they came to block, and he just doesn't have the gimp, the step, the speed that he normally would have, and a little unsure of his knee and how it's going to hold up.
He passed for 161, ran for 99 in the season opening win over Rice, but he's still looking a little tentative. 2nd and 2, he's still got 8 yards out of it. This ball nearly picked off, it is! Pearson at the 20 and out of bounds. Dakari Pearson, his 3rd interception of the year, and Texas knocking on the door with 1:17 to go before halftime.
Well, credit to Dorian McCullough, number 4, the cornerback on that side. Neely throws the ball out there, and good coverage and competitiveness here by McCullough. Just keep working, keep banging the ball out, and then Pearson comes from his free safety spot over there to make the play. Excellent job of keeping the ball alive, and good job by the Longhorn defense.
So the interception, the 3rd for Pearson, and Neely has now been picked off 4 times this season. Texas will have it 1st and 10. At the 25.
Well, those are the mistakes when you come in here to the University of Texas and you're a team just trying to hang in there that can really mount up, and the Longhorns are knocking on the door.
Play action, Sims. Complete, Thomas. Touchdown, Longhorns! Sloan Thomas.
Sloan Thomas having an excellent night. Picks one off here right in the middle of the field from Chris Sims. And does a spin move. He's in the out on the outside position. Going to come underneath here. Sloan Thomas settles in. Picks one off. Stop and start again. Come around and stretch out for the score. Good job showing his athleticism after the catch once again, Bill.
Interception by Pearson. Set it up. And Sloan Thomas capped it off as Sims gets his second TD pass of the night. Mangum hits the point after, and Texas now with a 25-point lead, 28-3. One more time.
Nice job of Sims, just waiting for Sloan Thomas to come open now. That's Thomas's fourth catch on the night. Good job of spinning. 55 yards and a score. Good job by the young man from Klein, Texas.
Pretty good rivalry, friendly, albeit among these receivers to top one another, and they all want that end zone, don't they?
No doubt about it. Hey, that's what's fun. You make a big play, you get in the end zone, hey, you pad Chris Sims' stats a little bit. Hell, they like that. Chris has done a good job throwing the football this year. There's no doubt about it. A couple of scores here tonight. One to Williams early in the ball game, and now that one to Sloan Thomas.
So Texas gets two touchdowns in the final 2 minutes of the half. 142 on Benson's 1 yard run, and then the pick by Pearson, and now Thomas scoring.
Well, that's what you come up with, explosive plays. We'll show that graphic here again. Two explosive plays on that drive alone. The interception, which is an explosive play in itself, and then converting with the big play there in the passing game to Sloan Thomas. Those are the things that Mack Brown talks about as far as making the difference in football games. And obviously here, the Longhorns have a big lead now, 28-3.
Third ranked Texas rolling. 108 to go as Texas to kick it off. Richmond McGee. Middleton from the three. Upended at the 18-yard line. Harris there to make the stop for Texas. And Houston now with 103 to go. Dana Dimble's got to decide, all right, just had the pick put back in your face. Now what?
I don't think that Dana Dimble's going to do a whole lot different offensively than what he came in here and planned to do. You go out there, you just have to execute. Don't make mistakes. Throw the ball, catch the ball, run the ball, block. You know, you just can't turn the ball over to an explosive offense here. We talked about the skill players for the Longhorns possibly being the best in the country, and I really believe that. They've got a lot of workhorses there, a lot of weapons to go with Cedric Benson. You got Chris Sims throwing the football, Roy Williams, Sloan Thomas emerging here. A lot of talented players for that Longhorn offense to go to, and those are things that, as a coach coming in here and playing this football team, you know that that's always going to be a problem for you. If you make mistakes, those players will take advantage of it.
I think that is Unger. Michael Unger is down for the University of Texas. Another in Texas, we're talking about injuries. And if you're going to have the great season that everybody wants, and Texas being touted as a national championship contender, a lot of times it comes down to health and what kind of depth you've got at those positions. And Vasher, not a serious injury, but missing tonight. Tubbs laying out with a concussion. Then you have Roy Williams with the hamstring. And even these special teams guys, if they've shown you tonight how important they are, let's take a look at Unger. Watch 29.
Yeah, just right there at the bottom of your screen. He tried to stop and just couldn't get stopped. His right knee, perhaps little ginger there as he goes down. Don't really know what happened with him, but obviously the young man's in pain out there on the field. Bill, you talked about injuries. There's a lot of things that happen with a football team, and this young man right here, Nathan Vasher, number 22, has got the cap on. He's a weapon. They want him on the field. They want him to be able to play. Smart move by Mack Brown, hold him out this week. You know, if you put the pads on him, and put the shoulder pads on, the helmet, he feels like he's going to be able to play as Unger gets up and coming off the field. But you want Nathan Vasher healthy when you play conference football, and probably a smart move not to let him play the football game tonight.
Well, Unger is walking without aid. And Sloan Thomas, we mentioned, just one catch coming in. And Mack Brown said, you never know when he's going to have his night. Well, so far it has been his night in the receiving category. And Houston first to 10 from its own 18. Neely with Reynolds behind him. Play clock at 4 seconds. They are thrown. And it is complete to Robinson. He got out of bounds. And Huff makes the play for Texas. Why applaud Dana Dimble here? He's got the big picture. You're not worried about He's worried about getting better and getting his offense going and trying to generate something, if not now, in the second half. But you're not going to do it by taking a knee or just running the ball into the line.
Well, just do the things that you're going to do from now on through the rest of the season. You're going to run this football team with Drew Barrick Neely. Let him throw the football. When he comes to the line of scrimmage, Bill, in the passing game, they minimize things for him where he has only two reads, not three reads like Chris Sims is doing, because he's not that experienced. They have two reads. They bring it. Go one level, bring it down to the second level, and he actually made the second level pass here. Good job by Neely delivering the pass.
Jackson made the stop that time, and a timeout called by Texas with 47 seconds to go. It is third down and two, and Texas thinking, all right, we stop them here and force a punt situation. You may get excellent field position again, an opportunity to tack on, who knows, it maybe three or six more.
There's no doubt about it. This is an explosive football team. The Longhorns got plenty of speed, plenty of players that go down the field, make one throw and catch, and perhaps, you know, at least kick a field goal. It's going to bring up a third down and short situation here for the Cougars. They'd like to convert and keep the Longhorns off the field.
Well, Corey Redding, we mentioned 12 tackles coming in this season, and the fumble recovery we saw against the UNT game. He's had 10 pressures in the quarterback. He shows up all the time.
There's no doubt about it. Corey Redding is perhaps the best defensive end in the country. I've said it a couple of times tonight. Making a play there, scooting down the line of scrimmage, pressuring the quarterback, taking Joffrey Reynolds here to task. And Corey Reynolds is a guy who came in the University of Texas as a linebacker, converted a defensive line, has turned himself into one of the best players in college football, hands down.
Third and two at the 26. Out of the shotgun is Barrick Neely for Houston. Pitches it on the option. That's a loose ball. Knocked away. Still alive. And let's see. Houston maintains possession. And now they'll get that fourth down opportunity to try to kick it away.
And it's going to all because of number 40, Corey Redding, coming off his defensive end spot. Watch his play, folks. He reads it. Hey, I'm going to hit that quarterback. Bingo. Forces a tough pitch. Hard to handle on the outside. He has to throw it overhand over Corey Redding's head. The pitch is awry. Credit Derek Johnson coming up, making a play. The speedy linebacker. Good job by the defense. Setting up field position now. The Longhorns have a chance to get the ball inside of the 50-yard line on the punt.
The crowd is still aching over that hit. They showed it on the big screen here, and they're just this, oh, as Corey Redding causing havoc again. And Pearson back for the Longhorns. It is fourth and 18 following the timeout. Kicking situation for the Cougars. And Texas, you bring them all here, Gary? You set up a return.
Well, you can set up the return. That's not a problem. I think that Mac Brown would like to get positive return yardage here. Don't do anything stupid. At least put your offense out there in good field position, which I don't think is going to be in question. No need to go and try to block a punt, because you could run into the kicker. Get your offense out there, get some field position. You know, force your offense to operate and get field position where you can at least line up for a field goal.
All right, out of the end zone this time, Jimmy McClary. You see his average tonight, 34 per kick. He puts it for Pearson at the 47. Fair catch. Texas will have 24 seconds to go to see what they can come up with here.
I bet Dakari Pearson was told, go ahead and fair catch it. Don't worry about it. We're just going to take the ball in protection here. Back to that play that Corey Redding made, Bill. I was watching the play here from the line of scrimmage, and just kind of keying in on Corey Redding. That's pretty fun to watch. When you see that big guy, as big as he is, go down, he sees the pitch go to his outside. He knows that's not his responsibility. I've got quarterback on this play. That's how they assign it. And then they have Derek Johnson running from the outside, who is responsible for the pitch man. Both of those players came up big on that play, and obviously set up a good punting situation, and the Longhorns are taking over now.
36-yard punt, and Texas first and 10 at the 46. And the pass is complete. Texas will hustle up here. Shanahan with the reception. Davis makes the tackle. And Shanahan getting his third reception of the night. Now Texas takes the timeout here with 15 seconds to go. Their final timeout of the half. And if you're thinking field goal range here, we'll see what happens as Mangum is 3 of 5 for 20, as long as been a 27-yarder this year, although he hit a 50 61-yarder last year against North Carolina. So we'll see what comes to this. And we have some more from Corey Redding we talked a lot about tonight and his thoughts about Chris Sims and the expectations with him.
Our expectations was to be number one coming out of high school, be number one coming out of college. We set our goals real high to achieve those goals, and we're getting real close, and just our last step to making them goals. And we're just so fortunate, so blessed to come into a great university together and leaving a great university together. And that's the only thing I'm gonna keep with me because, you know, Chris is a great guy. You know, through the 4 years I've been here, you know, I learned and bonded with Chris, and we share a lot of goals and things in common. So it's gonna be great leaving here with Chris.
They're the anchors of that great recruiting class that Mack Brown brought in here, that's considered best in the country by many, and is proving out to be just that with these two guys at least. Third down, or second and seven, and it is complete. Sloan Thomas, he'll get out of bounds inside the 30 at the 27-yard line. And Sowell's made the stop for Houston. And with 8 seconds left, Texas will get a field goal opportunity.
Well, Sloan Thomas is going to work across the field here and get up. You need to get to the 32-yard line to have a chance for the field goal. Good job getting inside there. The Longhorns probably have a chance to snap it one more time and throw a play. Got 8 seconds on the clock. You're going to see something here pretty quick into the outside.
Thomas lines up to the near side. First and 10, 8 seconds to go. Sims the quick drop. Just out of the reach of Thomas, has had him down near the 12-yard line. And now that'll bring on Dusty Bangham and Bo Trahan as well. Need to mention that.
Well, Sloan Thomas is going to work the outside and push off and watch him try to set in a little hole there. Chris sees him, but he just throws a little bit behind him.
So that sets the ball at the 34, a 44-yard attempt for Dusty Mangle. Sophomore from Mesquite. Trahan to hold. Funny business this time. The kick is up, and it is good. 44-yarder by Mangum, and Texas gets three more as the half expires. The Longhorns went up 14-0, gave up a field goal to Bell, and then scored three times in the final 1:42 of the first half. And the Longhorns lead it 31-3. Let's go to Jim Knox with head coach Mack Brown.
All right, thank you, Bill. Mack, you got to be extremely pleased. 31-3 at halftime. Offense is rolling. Chris Sims over 100 yards through the air. Cedric Benson close to 100 yards on the ground. You got it working on all cylinders.
Well, Jim, we are pleased. We were concerned coming in because Houston's 2-0 and a better football team, but we didn't respond at halftime 3 weeks ago against North Texas. This football team needs to be grown up. We need to do a better job in this third quarter than we did 3 weeks ago.
Suffered a big blow. Roy Williams goes down. It looks like a hamstring injury, but it seems like everyone just picks up the space right there.
Well, that's why we recruit so hard. We got good players, and we'll get Roy well, and Sloan's doing a great job.
Let's talk about that defense real quick. Definitely, Barrick Neely, he has nowhere to run out there. Longhorns defense is swarming.
Well, the guys have played really well. We haven't given them an opportunity to even get in our end into the field except for the turnover. So we've done a good job of taking care of the ball. We nearly stripped another ball there at the end of the half. We need to force some more turnovers, but pleased with our defense right now.
Appreciate the time, Mac. Good luck in the second half. Appreciate it. Right now, we're going to head to a break, then back. We'll check scores around the country and also check in with this Longhorn band. Stay with us. Halftime.
For the first down, 16-1 in total yards. Yeah, all Texas.
Well, everything is in the favor of the Longhorns, even a key possession here. 20 minutes, they've had the ball. Everything's going well for them. 0-for-6 here on third downs for Houston. Obviously, they're not converting first downs and controlling the football at all. The Longhorns done everything they've wanted to do tonight.
Dustin Bell will kick it off here for the Houston Cougars as Texas up 31-3 and scoring 17 points inside the final 2 minutes of the half. We'll get first crack offensively. Selvin Young slipped but did not touch. Finally is corralled near the 17-yard line. Selvin Young's a guy that's created a lot of excitement here in Austin with his early play. Freshman also from Houston, Jersey Village High School. 17 yards in return, and Texas will have it first and 10, and the Longhorns will come out with a 31-3 lead. And I think Mac Brown was talking to Jim there at the half about, I don't want a North Texas repeat, so it'll be interesting to see how this first series goes.
Well, they're going to come out and try to dominate again. I think they do want to get Chance Mock in the game. Jim Knox talked about that. Chance Mock is the backup quarterback. He needs some quality snaps where he can go out there and try to drive the ball down the field and get some good game experience.
Sims pitches. Benson moves to the 22, maybe 23-yard line. Benson needing just a couple to go over the 100-yard mark. Clay made the tackle. Cedric in the first half, 21 carries, 97 yards, and that'll put him over the century mark. And the leading receiver was Sloane Thomas with 5 for 71.
You take a look here at these players for this football team. Chris Sims, these are their national rankings. Benson, Roy Williams, and then Nathan Vasher in punt returns. Leaders in the country. They've got skilled players that are excellent here in converting, and obviously the Longhorns are showing all of that talent tonight.
Braxton making the tackle on Benson after a 7-yard tote for Cedric this time.
Well, yeah, let's take a look at this here. Nathan Vasher, first in the nation punt returns. Roy Williams, third receiving. Chris Sims doing a good job, pass efficiency. Cedric Benson, rushing yards per game, first. These are national rankings, folks. That's how talented this football team is.
First and 10, ball on the 30-yard line. Benson. This game, this half starting the way the game did, although Benson got rocked hard that time by Sewells and Milligan.
Well, Milligan comes up in his free safety spot and lays a lick on Cedric Benson, tackles him pretty high around the shoulders. If you're going to watch Milligan come in here from this free safety spot, he's a big hitter, the leading tackler on this football team, and watch the pop he puts on Benson. Good tackle. I think that kind of sent Cedric for a loop. Big safety, 6'3", NFL prospect. Big hitter back there in the secondary for the Cougars.
Benson again on the second and four. Joe Clay making the stop.
Well, the Longhorns starting the game, the second half, much like they started the first half, running the ISO play. It's the play they ran to perfection last week against North Carolina late in the ball game, just grinding it out. A week ago, Bill, they played at North Carolina. Their offense really wasn't very, very effective in the third quarter. I know Mac Brown wants to come out and sustain a drive here early on in this football, in this third quarter, you know, to establish they're a balanced football team throughout the football game. The Longhorns had to come back in the fourth quarter and play very well to win that ball game against the Tar Heels.
Sims on a first and 10, scrambling, flag is thrown, and he throws this one away.
They'll try to do the old stop and go with Sloane Thomas at the top of the screen, and Chris Sims pumps and is going to try to get the ball down to Thomas, but the pressure came to him. Protection broke down. Going to have a penalty here. He's going to back up the Longhorns.
Penalty-wise, Texas on the year, 19 for 159
holding
coming in.
Offense.
And penalties are penalty. They're always going to be a point of contention with any coach.
First down.
Regardless if you're up 31-3 or not.
We talked about explosive plays with Mac Brown, running, passing, turnovers. The one thing he didn't talk about was penalties, and really penalties aren't part of that equation as well. But the Longhorns have showed that, you know, they're a good football team, but they're well coached. And when you're a well coached football team and you're disciplined, you don't have those unfortunate penalties.
First down and 20 to go. The ball on the 30. They've got to get across midfield for the first down. And Sims finds Benson out of the backfield and got a blocker or two. Cedric to the 40, the 45. A terrific collision. He got the first down. Goodness gracious, and lost the football. And Houston recovers.
Big hit at the midfield. Cedric Benson cuts back and the Cougar defense converge on it. Excellent job with the screenplay. They've set it up very well. Chris Sims going to drop it down to Cedric Benson, who's got players in front of him. See the blockers coming out and running. Watch the hit here at midfield, right on the football. And the ball is going to come out. It's pulled out at the end. And the ball goes down to the ground, and the Cougars recover.
Woodard with a fumble recovery. And Benson a little shaken up after that hit. And he got a blow to the head there before the fumble. First and 10 at the 48 of Houston following the turnover, Cougar football, and they hand it off. And another quarterback in the game for the University of Houston as they've decided to take Neely out, and they don't go with Eddie.
Well, that is Nick Eddie.
Yeah, I beg your pardon. Yeah,
he's the number two quarterback, and he's in there. And I'll let Barrett Neely, you know, as a young quarterback, sometimes you can learn more standing on the sidelines in a big game like this instead of actually being out on the field. He's going to have a chance to see what the Longhorn defense is doing from the sideline perspective, and this may help him in the long run.
You might recall that Eddie came in the first series when Neely went out. And then Neely came right back. This one off to Reynolds. And Reynolds down to the 47-yard line.
Well, this is the second time now tonight, the only second time that the Cougars have gotten into Longhorn territory. The first time on an interception return, got them down, they scored a field goal, and now the Cougars are about the 47-yard line of the Longhorns. Pretty good play there, first and second down. They move it down methodically. That's what they need to do here to have a chance. They don't want to be in third and long situations. Third and four here, give Nick Eddie a chance to convert this third down.
Boyd made that tackle, third and five here at the 47 of Texas. Eddie steps up, delivers, and incomplete, intended for Brian Robinson, the senior from Daytona Beach, Florida. And it'll be a fourth down for the Cougs. So Eddie came to Houston from American River Junior College in California, where he threw for 2,500 yards and 16 touchdowns. And then as a sophomore at Houston, he threw for 1,023 yards and 6 TDs last year, at 8 interceptions. So he is not without experience, even though he's played little this season. Fourth and five, McCleary kicks it away, gets the high kick. Pearson signals fair catch and then lets it go. And Houston downed it near the 19-yard line. We'll take a brief break. Watching Texas football, 31-3 Longhorns, 11:01 to go after that 26-yard punt. Texas getting possession with 11:01 to go, third period, 31-3. First and 10 at the 19 of the Longhorns. Bill Land, Gary Reasons, Jim Knox with you. And Longhorns putting some different folks in the game. Ivan Williams gets his first carry of the night, and he's brought down by Lance Everson. Williams is a 6'1", 240-pound junior from Cleveland, Texas.
Good chance to get some other players into the football game, get some game experience, give Cedric Benson a blow.
Yeah, Benson, if he is done, and he might be, with 25 carries for 120 yards. Handoff and swarm of tacklers there, led by Joe Clay, and also Milligan making the tackle. Benson back in for the run. And with the injury to Roy Williams, you'll also see the shuttling of the receiver. You see B.J. Johnson, who has not had much thrown his direction here tonight, came in with four receptions for 47 yards. Benson and Shanahan, three each on the receiving end, behind Sloan Thomas, five to face Texas. Sims in trouble, got it away just in time, and complete to Thomas. He's not headed for out of bounds as he is brought down at the 40-yard line, and a pickup of 16 on the play. Malone makes the tackle for the Cougars, and Sims just in the nick of time delivering that one, Gary.
Well, one-on-one cover to the outside. Sloan Thomas showing that he can push it down the field with his speed, come back, and then try to make something happen after the catch. Good protection there. Robin picks up on the blitz. Watch Sloan Thomas as he tries to elude the defender, try to make a big play here, get by him. There's no one back behind that guy, and Sloan Thomas gets by him. It's a touchdown for the Longhorns.
Thomas and Jeffrey to the top of the screen. Johnson to the lower part on a first and 10 at the 40 of Texas. Sims hands off to Benson. And Benson stutters to the 48 and a half yard line.
One thing about the Cougar defense up front, Bill, not a lot of stars up there, but they've got solid players. They actually rolled 12 guys on their defensive front between the defensive tackles and the defensive ends. 12 players. They're going to play with depth on this football team, not just tonight, but throughout the season. They feel like they have a lot of good players that can step up and make plays. They've got some young players also, so getting them some game experience and playing a lot of them is going to be beneficial to them in the long run.
Second and six at the Longhorn 44. Houston trailing 31-3. And again, Williams. And he rolls in the Texas sideline into Houston territory at the 48-yard line. Williams second carry, and Milligan makes the tackle.
Good job of bouncing out the big back. Looks inside, takes it to the outside. Pretty good speed. Watch here as the right side offensive line does a good job of turning it in, and big guy got a little pressure inside, so he takes it outside. Milligan's had to make a lot of tackles at free safety. You know, he's had 170 tackles last year, Bill, in an 0-11 campaign. That's good and bad when your defensive and your free safety is your leading tackler. But he is a quality player back there for the Cougars.
Ivan Williams getting his first carries of the season tonight here in this period. First and 10 at the 47. And Ivan's got 14 yards on his first two. Sims chased out of the pocket, completes the pass to Chad Stevens, the senior tight end. And Woodard makes the tackle. Another nice pickup, though, for Longhorns as...
Don't you like the ball that Chris Sims throws? Real nice touch, real tight spiral, real easy. Doesn't have to do a whole lot here. Just zips it out there. Quick release. He's able to throw the ball around traffic, over the top. Has a good presence in the pocket. He knows how to move right to left. This is all seasoning that this quarterback has come under here now in his senior year. 4 years at the helm here for the Longhorns.
Second down and four. Ball at the 41 of Houston. Williams falls forward, got the first down, or very close it would appear. See where they spot it. Ronnie Braxton, senior from Denison, Texas, made the tackle for Houston.
Nothing fancy for the Longhorns, just block and tackle here. They're doing a good job of blocking and running the football with Williams behind them, and also Cedric Benson. No doubt he's had a good night tonight. Benson's number is 124, and Ivan Williams has picked up 14 over two carries.
They'll bring it out for a measurement here as Chris Sims stays to see the proceedings. With 7:52 to go in the third quarter. Mentioned Texas in the schedule. Jim talked about at halftime. They're at Tulane next week before opening Big 12 play here against Oklahoma State. Kind of interesting that Mack Brown going to Tulane, where he previously coached. Of course, just coming off the North Carolina win that he had so much success there with the Tar Heels.
I don't know what the odds makers would put on that, playing your two former teams.
Didn't get out state on the schedule, though, did he?
No.
Of course, assisted at Iowa State, Oklahoma. See those teams as well. People remember that game, I think, October 12th. Everybody's got it circled in Dallas at the Cotton Bowl. First and 10 here, 37. Incomplete, intended for Jeffrey. Malone was covering. Sims tonight in the passing game, just the lone interception, but he's 17 of 24 for two touchdowns and over 200 yards now, 207 yards. His longest, a 25-yarder, and that was to Williams for the touchdown. And the same Sloan Thomas was a 25-yarder as well on his touchdown reception. Second and 10 at the 37. Williams got a block and then bruises his way down to the 30-yard line where Milligan makes the tackle. A 7-yard pickup for Ivan Williams.
Milligan comes over to make the tackle. Now he's 6'3", 215 pounds as a safety, but watch Williams here bang into him and take him for a little bit of a ride. Milligan says, hey, bus, slow down.
Well, Williams missed some spring play because of a knee injury. Last year, he ran for 519 yards and five scores and had a 152-yard game against Texas Tech. So another very capable player. With what you've witnessed with Roy Williams tonight, you can't have too many of them. Third and two. Williams leans forward, lost the football. Still on the ground, and Texas indicating they've got it.
And uniquely, Bill, probably a first down.
Yeah.
stopped behind the line of scrimmage, and the ball is pops out.
Tillman Holloway
recovered.
Tillman Holloway, junior out of Colorado, third-year starter, coming up with that fumble.
Take a look here. Good job as Cougar defense is coming over the top, and that Davis on the backside pulling the ball out, pops forward. Tillman Holloway coming up for the fumble recovery.
Soels had made the hit that caused the fumble for Houston, but Texas maintains possession. And here's Young. He gets hit hard. Another loose pigskin. Selvin Young bursts through that opening, but Houston recovers this fumble.
A lot of things people think special about Selvin Young, number three. His first spot at tailback tonight, gets the ball, and I tell you, he hits the hole. A whole lot different pace than Cedric Benson or Ivan Williams. When Selvin Young hits the hole, it's a whole different ball game.
Ronnie Braxton with a fumble recovery for the Cougars, and Dana Dimmel sees his club go back on the offense, trailing 31-3. We'll be right back. Brown talks so much about, and so we'll update you here, Gary.
Obviously, all in the favor of the Longhorns. Four plays over 16 yards in the passing game and five running the ball. And the forced turnovers here, obviously, three of those. Good job by the Texas Longhorns in all areas. And I think that's when you add that up for Mac Brown, he's going to be very pleased.
Now Houston comes out throwing with Eddie getting the completion here. Jackson makes the tackle. John Clark, the receiver. And Texas faced defensively now second and six for Houston. But Texas plays at Tulane. Houston has already played Tulane, lost to the Green Wave 34-13. That was the game they had seven turnovers, so they know all about the turnover situation. Here's Eddie on second and six. Drills it, and I mean drills it for the completion and the first down. As you see, Babers wrestling there with the receiver on the play, Middleton, Brandon Middleton.
Nick Eddie's a big quarterback, 6'4", 250 pounds, does a good job standing in the pocket. Just reading the receiver, looking for a break, and he's going to deliver the ball on timing. Good protection up front. Nothing too drastic there for the Longhorns coming in his face. Delivers a good ball to the outside. Pretty good coverage, though.
Well, Babers hanging on, and Middleton shows you a little of his spunk as he's fighting for every yard here. Forget the fact this team's down 31-3. Eddie lofts this one out, and it is complete. Nicely done by Bell on the receiving end. And Huff was covering on the play.
Well, he's a slot receiver to the outside, and he gets outside of Michael Huff, covering on the play, and Bell does a good job of working upfield and then working to the outside. You're going to see him here working. Watch him work to the outside and get away from Huff. Good job of delivering the ball by Nick Eddie up and over the top and coming back and making a nice grab. Actually, it may have not been a catch, but they're going to rule it a completion.
Yeah.
The ball, actually, the ball comes out as he hits the ground. It's probably a good call.
Kikoa Bell, seven receptions coming in, leading this team. This one is complete inside the 30 for another first down by Eddie, and all of a sudden, Houston's got something going offensively as Babers makes the tackle on Middleton again.
What do you see there? You see two or three explosive-type plays, big plays in the passing game. The Cougars are moving down the field pretty quickly.
Middleton had a touchdown in the game against Texas last year. He averaged 24 yards a reception last year, and he's doing it so far this year through three games. So he is a big play, an explosive playmaker. First to 10 to 29. Eddie. And he is brought down back on the 43-yard line. Cedric Griffin coming on the blitz, the redshirt freshman out of San Antonio Holmes, and Griffin makes the big play.
No doubt about it, just bringing speed and get up there on Eddie before he can turn and look for a receiver. Blitz protection was not there. That's Joffrey Reynolds on the outside, misses the block, and good job that time making a play in the backfield. When you got speed on defense, you can do those things. You can pick your spots and bring an outsider, a guy from the outside, and make a big play in the backfield.
Loss of 13 for the Cougars. Second and 23 now. Line of scrimmage, the 43 of Texas. Eddie in trouble again. Steps up, buys some time, and throws it away. Good pressure by the Texas defense once again. And even though the shutout is not there, you know this Texas defense, been told by Carl Reese, let's not give many touchdowns, guys.
Well, watch the right side of your screen. Number 8, Cedric Griffin's going to track all the way, try to get there. Runs into a roadblock. Nick Eddy does a smart thing out of the pocket. Go ahead and throw the ball away and avoid the sack.
You're saying he shouldn't have taken on Corey Redding? See who's tougher? Eddy faces a 3rd and 23. The 43 of the Longhorns, and the fans out of their seats for this defensive set. And it is complete across the 40 to the 37-yard line. And McCardell makes the reception, Jackson the tackle.
Well, that's a good call against the pressure defense. The Longhorns brought a little bit inside, and they're going to throw the screen over the top. That's exactly what you want to do offensively, because outside you have to execute and block. Let's take a look at the wide receivers. You're going to see the blocks here on the outside. And the Longhorns do a pretty good job of tracking on the inside. You see Lee Jackson, number 23, coming and making a nice play on the screen.
And McCardell gets the reception. That is his first of the season for the Cougars. And they'll have to punt it away and choose to. At 4th and 18, the ball in the 38. Trying to back him up and to kill it inside the 10. Can't do it, though, as it goes in the end zone for the touchback. And Texas will get the ball 1st and 10 on the Longhorn 20. When we come back, it's Texas 31, Houston 3. 31, Cougars 3, Bill and Gary Reasons. Jim Knox with you here tonight in Austin as Texas, number 3 in the country, trying to go 3-0. And Sims and crew will bring it out 1st and 10 at the 20-yard line following the punt into the end zone. Last drive stalled with the penalty. Sims comes out firing, and Thomas drops the football. Won't see that very often. Sloan's had a great night.
He's had a real good night. Just one got away from him.
6 receptions, 87 yards for Sloan Thomas. 8 different receivers have caught the football tonight. I mean, talk about spreading it around. Chris Sims, his 17 completions to 8 different receivers. 2nd and 10, ball on the 20. Benson got clogged up there and loses a yard or two on the play. And Carr makes the tackle, the 6-foot, 300-pound freshman.
Well, the Longhorns still have their number ones in there, both defensively the last series and now offensively. Although Cedric Benson's coming out getting a little blow here on 3rd down, but that's pretty normal. They bring Brett Robin in there on 3rd down to do that job. Brett's done a good job the last couple of years on the 3rd down situation.
Shanahan also in the game as a wideout. He stretched out here on the trips right as it's 3rd and 13, the ball on the 17. And complete to Robin. Almost got it. And going to be a little shy at the 29-yard line. Appears 4th and 1 coming up. Davis and Everson there to stop him for the Houston Cougars.
Well, I love the spunk of Chris Sims. He runs to the line up there like, come on, coach, let's go for it on 4th and 1. Ahead 31-3 here, and he looks at the sideline, sees a punt team running on the field, and he's thinking, okay, we'll go back and do it again some other time.
2:20 and counting here in the 3rd period, and that brings on punter Brian Bradford from Lufkin, Texas. Everybody up for Houston as Bradford does get it off. It is taken 30-35, and then the hard tackle at the 37-yard line as Adorian McCullough makes the stop after a 41-yard punt. And send it back down here to Jim Knox.
All right, thank you very much, Bill. I thought we had a chance Monkside. At first, he was on the stationary bicycle, warming up the legs, and then he said didn't get the nod yet from head coach Mac Brown, but right now he's standing next to him trying to get his attention before the night's up. You get the feeling Chance Monk will definitely be in with this 31-3 lead, Bill.
Is he running from the camera?
Yeah. Chance will keep bugging Mac. He'll get in. He's probably showing him that tape of Paul Thompson throwing that touchdown pass at OU last week in that 68-0 game in the final minute. Say, come on, coach, come on now. We got to stay up for the Sooners here. We got to play me. Eddie. And incomplete with a flag thrown. Babers was covering on the play.
Well, nudged him out of bounds, perhaps, and Cougars may get a call here on the interference penalty.
Tyson, 83, the intended receiver. Wait for the call here.
Holding. On the defense. 10-yard penalty. First down.
Bill, you joked about points a couple of minutes ago, and it's not a laughing matter because these teams who are positioning themselves for high rankings, and obviously the Longhorns are, points come into play in the BCS rankings. And, you know, although you don't want to,
even though they've limited the computer figuring of blowouts, they have not limited the voters figuring on looking at scores of games and where they rank teams in the respective polls. And that is a factor in the BCS as well. And
well, it's a dominance thing. If teams are dominating by a wide margin, if you see team A dominate by 50 points, but you see team B only dominate by 20 points or 30 points, you know, you're mentally going to have a nod for the team that scored more points on perhaps a similar opponent. So teams are you know, cognizant of the scores that are around them, and Mack Brown has got to make decisions that affect not only his players on the field, but the long-term consequences of the scores of the football game.
Incomplete again for Eddie on second and 10. Well, and the other thing that Coach Brown was telling us earlier this week was that he said, you don't want to run the score up, but another thing, you've got to get players ready to play. And Chance Mock needs to be able to throw the football. Now, tonight it was Roy Williams. Next week or tonight later, it could be Chris Sims, and you want that guy having experience. And I think most coaches on both sidelines are just well aware of that anymore.
Jim Knox used the furries earlier in the ball game. You're one play away.
Yeah.
And that's exactly right. Any position on the field, and the quarterback one being the most profile, obviously you want to get your young quarterback in there and get some reps.
On third and 10, Huff makes the tackle on the play. Pass completed to Bell again. And we'll see where they measure this. Should be. Very good. It's going to be a first down.
Now they've still got the starting group out there for the Longhorn defense. They're rolling a few people in the defensive front, which they had planned to do. They're only playing with five or six defensive backs throughout the year. They pretty much scrapped their dime package because of depth and injuries. They're going with five defensive backs. They've got the 3-3 package out there now, three defensive linemen and three linebackers with the five defensive backs around them.
On a first and 10, the ball at the 40, and Eddie pitches it out to Bell again, and he breaks a tackle and got the first down as he crosses the 30 to the 27, maybe 26-yard line. Reed Boyd made the final stop there. Nice job by Bell, and you see some of the ability this young guy has.
Now Michael Huff, number 7, has got coverage on him. He's going to come downhill to him and try to make a tackle, but good stop and start here by Bell, getting outside, and Huff trying to make the high tackle. Goes over the shoulder pads, and Bell gets a first down in the Longhorn territory here.
Bell's freshman year, he had 54 receptions. Last year, a medical redshirt when he got hurt with an ankle injury and only caught 8 balls, and this year came in with 7 catches into this game. Eddie completes this one, and the tackle is made by Huff again on Bell. Well, and second and really no gain, it looks like.
Bill, when the Houston coaches watch this particular play, they're going to see a good thing for their quarterback. Watch him step up into the pocket and elude McCullough coming from the outside. Hutorian said, hey, I got one here. But no, he steps up and he delivers the ball and avoids a sack, more importantly.
Bell now 4 receptions tonight to lead Houston. And Eddie is 8 of 13 for 86 yards. It's a 2nd and 9 for the Cougars on the 25 of Texas, 23 seconds to go in the period. And the handoff right up the middle. Reynolds back in the act across the 20-yard line.
And it's amazing what balance does. When you throw the ball down the field, those runs that they were trying to get accomplished in the first and second quarter, they weren't there, folks. This Longhorn defense was tough. Now they pop a little run in there, you know, for a, you know, 4 or 5 yard gain. It brings up a 3rd short situation, which is manageable for the Houston offense.
Joffrey Reynolds being credited for 6 as that ends the 3rd quarter. So Eddie has the Cougars on the move, but they've yet to get in the end zone through 3. Texas with a 31-3 lead after 3. We're back for the 4th quarter in Austin. We move to quarter number 4. The Longhorns led by 31-3 at the half. And it is Houston that is now charging after a scoreless third period. Cougs third and three at the 19 of Texas. Out of the shotgun, quarterback Nick Eddy. Flushed out of the pocket. And had to throw it to Robinson. It was underthrown, but Corey Redding was right in his face. In the face of the quarterback, Eddy, I should say.
Actually, pretty good job of Eddie just getting rid of the football. Everything kind of broke down. He just throws it out there. Corey Redding on the bottom of the screen here. He's actually playing a spy technique on the tight end, but he doesn't go out and rush. So I tell you what, I'm going to go ahead and rush the quarterback and see if I can get me a sack. Almost does.
Well, Houston had 42 yards of offense at the half, Gary. They doubled that within the third quarter. They had 84, and not that they put in the end zone yet, but they have finally shown a little bit of rhythm on the offensive end. Across the middle, and Bell takes it down inside the six to the 5-yard line. Dakari Pearson made the tackle.
Good job of execution by the Cougars. Eddie finds Bell on the quick little slant there. Slows down, gets the first down. Watch him look to his left here. 1-2-3, bingo. Deliver the ball over the linebackers, and Bell shows his athleticism by spinning and bringing it inside the 5-yard line.
Texas, by the way, 403 yards of total offense tonight as we start the fourth period. Right now it's Houston. First and goal from officially the 4. No backs. Bell in motion. Well, one back, I beg your pardon. That's Reynolds, and he burst through down near inside the 1-yard line as Pearson made the tackle.
One Reynolds on the carry.
Joffrey Reynolds, Tyler Lee.
Well, I think this Texas defense would have liked to hold the Cougars out of the end zone completely. Field goals, they're not too concerned about those, but they probably wanted to get a shutout here. They shut out North Texas a couple weeks ago here in this stadium and would like to stop and get in the end zone. Brings up a scoring opportunity here, and I think Nick Eddy ties over for the score.
And Houston's on the board with a touchdown for the first time tonight. Nick Eddy takes it in, and Eddy makes it a 31-9 game as the Cougars. Pretty impressive drive, and much of it with the arm of Nick Eddy, some pinpoint passing.
Well, Nick Eddy stayed in the pocket well, thrown the ball. He's found Bell, who's been productive as a receiver for him. The offense has kind of hung in there, and I think that maybe this Texas defense may be a little tired here, perhaps. They've been out there a little while, and credit the Houston Cougar offense for being persistent. Going to go for two here on the point on the conversion, Bill.
Down 31-9, a flip in the end zone. It is complete, and they get the two-point conversion. Middleton, the receiver, and they made that look easy.
Well, it was an ME, Bill. There was no one out there covering the receiver. That's a smart play by the Cougars. Obviously, there was a miscommunication in the secondary.
Makes it 31-11. We'll be back. Houston getting on the board, and a two-point conversion, 31-11. You know, we always show you flashbacks of great plays. Well, we've got a different flashback today of earlier today where our sideline man, Jim Knox, was in Lubbock.
You never know where Jim Knox is going to pop up, do you? Knoxie?
Yeah. No, not at all. I'm almost near you guys, high above Jones Stadium, guys. That's right. Construction underway, as you mentioned earlier. A brand new press box will be in play by next season. This is going to be nice.
I like the, you know, Knoxie looking fine as always in that coat and tie, but the accessory with the hard hat was finished it off.
And he is a jet setter. There's our man, Jim Knox, on the sidelines here. Double dipping, we call it in the business.
Yeah, Bill, all we did was we took the corporate jet, you know, of course, Lubbock to Austin. We made it in no time.
That was nice of Roop to send it for you. I've never seen it.
Yeah, thank you. I think it was the crop duster, but, you know, we got here in good. We got here plenty of time for kick.
Watch out. Here's Texas returning the kick. Selvin Young at the 30, the 20. Touchdown. There is a flag. It's going to come back as Selvin Young did some crop dusting of his own, Gary.
Well, he flew right by everybody, that's for sure. That's why Selvin Young is looked at as perhaps a real bright spot here in the future for the Longhorn offense in the kick return game, doing duties on kick return and punt return. And
holding.
Get a hold.
Receiving team. 10-yard penalty. From the spot of the foul.
Now that just might be a sign of things to come, though, for Salvin Young and what his capabilities are, showing a lot of speed, and ability to just break through and make a big play, especially in a kicking game.
Would have been a 91-yarder.
Yeah, Bell's not going to have a chance. Bell kind of just got his bell rung, as you would say.
Well, again, no, it doesn't count, but it just shows you the talent and the capable people here. You got Basher sitting out as a terrific punt returner tonight, and look at Young picking that one back.
And now, clothesline.
That was a
clothesline.
Penalty flag as Vincent about had his hat taken off. Davis, the culprit.
He knows it. I kind of grimaced when I saw that, and I said, ooh. That's a pretty good shot up around the neck. Watch here, as Cedric mentioned, turns to his left in the clothesline. Bingo. That's not an intentional, just trying to make a tackle. I don't think anything malicious.
Fans upset because that was a 5-yard penalty as the incidental contact with it.
Well, they didn't call a personal foul. All they did was call a 5-yard penalty on the play, which is basically a face mask. It's a 5-yard face mask.
If you intentionally grab the face mask, it's the 15-yard.
I think this is more of a. Well, I tell you what, looking at it from that angle is a pretty good hit. Might have touched it with his hand going down on the line, but nonetheless, it's first and 5 for the Cougs, or the Longhorns.
Ball on the 28 for Texas this time. 13:31 to go in the ball game. And Benson takes it across the 30. Benson with just an incredible high school career with 8,400 yards and 127 touchdowns at Midland Lee. Yeah, he's used to being the workhorse. Joe Clay made the tackle here. Cedric tonight, 29 carries, 124 yards, and one touchdown. Second and 3 at the 30. And Benson out to the 35. We had more on Cedric Benson from Mack Brown and where he has improved and come along this year.
Cedric, it was a hard thing for him because he carried it every play at Midland Lee, but he won 2 championships in this stadium and he carries it really well. He's so much further ahead right now than he was even at the end of last year. He's quicker, he's stronger, he's more mature. He's becoming one of our better blockers.
He started the last 7 games last year and ended up with 223 carries. First and 10 here, Sims at an hour and finds a receiver. And it's Benson again, about 2 yards shy of the first down where Shermer makes the tackle, Matt Shermer.
That's Cedric Benson's actually his 4th reception of the night, Bill. Pretty impressive run of the football, throwing the football. Cedric Benson, I talked about early in the ball game, touching the football. He's got 30 rushes, 4 receptions. Get the ball in that young man's hands. He's going to make something happen for your offense.
Hey, Bill and Gary, really, what you look at Cedric Benson, what makes him a good running back, you look at the yards he gains after contact. Going into this game, 257 yards on the ground, 144 of those yards after contact. Guys, that's a sign of a good running back, and it seems like the more touches he gets, the stronger and the better he gets.
Yeah, and this might be an example of it right here. As he's the defense wearing down, and Benson revving up on his carry now at 31 for 137 yards.
Some of the great ones obviously do get better as time goes on. I remember watching Ricky Williams here doing a few ball games, Bill, and he seemed to get better as the football game went on. Saw the holes better. His line was in sync, and things just happened real well for him. And I think Cedric Benson is following suit.
First and 10 at the 49. He got 8 on the last carry. And Benson slides forward to the 46-yard line. Well, we were just talking during the last break. Braxton making the tackle there. The Gary that you see a new career high in rushes. We kind of got the feeling here in the background. You know he wants to play Chance Mock and some of these other guys. But it's like, hey, fellas, go get me a touchdown. Let's reestablish that we can score and do it in the second half, and then we'll give you a breather.
Well, they've got to play competitive football games. They can't just go out there for three quarters and say we're done. I think Mack Brown is trying to put the mindset into his offense and his defense. Guys, it's a four-quarter effort. We need everybody to go and play. And, you know, they need to get some experience into that fourth quarter and see what they can do and be productive throughout the entire football game. Last week, the third quarter, not very good for the Longhorn offense, no doubt about it. But they did very well in the fourth quarter. Now a chance to be productive in the third and even into the fourth quarter.
Well, as you see Benson again on the carry, remember, they got 27-0 against UNT at the half. Didn't score in the second half. North Carolina, they led 24-0. They had the poor third quarter, then ripped them again in the fourth. And point trying to be made. Third and four now at the 43. And Benson's up to 143 yards. Sims the throw. Flushed out. Unloads and incomplete. Looking for Robin out of the backfield, and that'll make it fourth down and bring on Brian Bradford, the punter for University of Texas.
Yeah, Chris Sims, little pressure here, trying to find a receiver downfield. Nothing there, and pressure breaks down. Don't you see him there, and then for the backside. Pressure on Sims, and he has to throw it a little earlier than he'd like to Robin. Falls a little bit short.
Texas to kick it away with Bradford standing on his own 44. Line of scrimmage is the 43 of Houston. And is caught inside the 10. Bell, whoo, speaking of getting it rung, big time. Edwards, Brock Edwards just leveled Bell. And that 34-yard punt came to a quick halt on the return. We'll take a break, 31-11 Texas. What did it sound like when Edwards was able to ring the bell? You listen. Brock Edwards.
That's fun. Big tight end come down on coverage.
Tell Bell that. Ask him how much fun it was. First and 10, the ball on the 18-yard line.
Touch on him again, because I was in
Houston down 31-11. Eddie comes out firing. Robinson couldn't find the handle. Bryan, who had six receptions for 82 yards coming in here tonight, has only got two grabs tonight. Bell leads him with five. Texas is paced by Sloan, six.
That's pretty good toss by Eddie right there. Yeah. Just dropped by Robinson on the outside. Huff had coverage on it, backed off a little bit. Receiver came back nicely. Ball was there, just got to make the grab.
Eddie is 9 of 16 for 101 yards. Second and 10 here, 18-yard line, line of scrimmage. Got it off to Reynolds. And then he is brought down by Corey Redding.
Well, we see Nick Eddy doing a good job of moving this offense here for the Houston Cougars. And obviously he's on the field. Didn't start the ball game tonight. Barrett Neely, the redshirt freshman, was in there. And on the first play that he had, he ran out of bounds, got nicked, and really was never the same coming back and playing in the football game. But Nick Eddy's done a nice job here in the second half of this Cougar offense. And trying to get some positive things moving forward as they get ready for conference play.
Only the Cougars have scored in the second half. Third and eight. Throws this one away, looking for Robinson. Well, Gary mentioned Neely. Jim has more on Barrett Neely in his situation.
All right, Bill, it's just over the Houston sidelines. Barrett Neely was on the bench. He continues to rub his knee. It just tightened up at halftime. Couldn't go here in the second half, but he remains a big cheerleader for the Cougars offense. They already have one touchdown against his stingy Longhorn defense. We'll see what happens here.
Now, Texas defense only allowing 10.5 points per game through the first two with the shutout of UNT. And the punter is on. That is McCleary. Pearson at the 40. Got one block. Pearson jukes and jives and gets across out near the 50-yard line. Pearson, as Texas will get an excellent field position. Woodard made the tackle and a 40-yard punt with a 10-yard return.
Mason Basher's pretty fun to watch back there, but this young man, Pearson, shows that he's got some ability to make some people miss. Mike Brown's got a lot of weapons at his disposal, Bill.
Pearson had the big interception return earlier tonight. So with 8:58 remaining, Sims will huddle near the sideline and bring him out here. And Texas, 31-11 lead. Take a look at McCleary, the punter, after the kick.
Well, guys just kind of rack up for the punter sometimes. You know, a little game within a game here.
Bo Trahan says,
Bo says, no, this is my field. Get out of here.
Trahan, getting a touchdown tonight's not enough. Uncle, get me a kicker. See if I can flatten him. Well, that's why Trahan's the player that he is that he's out there continuing until that whistle blows. He's going to stay after people. Yeah, 31-11 Texas. With 8:58 remaining, Longhorns trying to tack on their 15th consecutive win here in Austin. As right now, with what's happened in the Big 12 non-conference late, Gary, it is Texas and OU kind of carrying the weight nationally, headed for that Cotton Bowl showdown. Colorado rebounded today after a couple of losses, defeating UCLA. Texas A&M played well, but the offense still struggling. They had a chance to make some noise with Virginia Tech. Kansas State, don't know the final on their game with USC. They're the other team that has a chance to move up in those rankings quickly. They had played three PUDs until today. First and 10, ball on the 49. Benson rolls across the 46 to the 44. Davis there to make the tackle. You think there's that kind of separation that OU and UT are clearly ahead of the others?
There probably is a separation because of the talent level and the things that are happening for those football teams. Remember this week, Bill, we talked with Mac Brown, and he, you know, just kind of strangely, he says, you know, I tape a lot of the games. He tapes the broadcasts and so forth all over the country, and he tries to get a feel for all these other teams in the conference, although they may not be playing them. And he watched a couple of the games. He watched the Nebraska game. To watch the Colorado game, trying to get a pace of how things are, and just, although not necessarily measuring his team against them, but just trying to see how other people are doing and other teams are doing in the conference. And overall, you know, he's just trying to evaluate where his team is. He doesn't really look down the road at those games, but more importantly, the game that's next. But I think it's a good mark of something smart that he has to do is kind of stay abreast of what's going on in the conference.
Yeah, and instead of just all of a sudden cramming.
Exactly.
Let's kind of, as the year goes on, you put things back on your mental checklist that, oh, yeah, I remember that game and what they did and that type of thing. Well, you got a great staff like they've got here. You're able to spend a little more time seeing the big picture. First and 10, ball on the 36, and Sims looking for the big play. Going to tuck it under this time. And Chris steps out of bounds at the 25, I should say, but he saw that first down marker. At least I think he did, and he made it. Braxton was covering on the play.
Well, Braxton, linebacker, 6 foot, 220 pounds, trying to bring down Chris Sims. He's 6'5", 230. A little bit different there. Chris Sims does a good job on the outside. Elusive enough. Enough speed to outrun the linebacker, actually.
It'll be second and very short. At the 36-yard line, Jeffrey and Johnson go wide to the right side. And Benson gets the first down, and Braxton there, Milligan also.
Kind of good news for the offensive line for the Longhorns. Jonathan Scott, number 73, is in the ballgame. He had had an ankle problem. He's in there playing a little tackle on the left side next to Tillman Holloway. You need depth on your offensive line because one of those guys go down, you have to shuffle some guys around. Move Bo Baker into guard, Derek Dockery out to tackle on one side. Just trying to find a combination that works best for this offense.
Benson on the first and 10. Couple of hard yards near the 21-yard line before Braxton makes the tackle. And Cedric Benson, 36 carries, 157 yards. We mentioned earlier, we showed you a graphic of some of the Longhorns and how they stood. And I think we mentioned nationally, it should have said Big 12, where Benson is the leading rusher in the Big 12. 12th in the country. Well, he'll certainly add some numbers there. 36 for 157. And he's had 9 runs for a first down. Second and 8 here. Benson breaks one and then slips at the 18-yard line before Sowells makes the tackle.
I can just tell that Cedric Benson wants to get another one in the end zone. Working really hard, trying to get there. Did real well in the second quarter, running off that left side. Kept banging that ISO play. Just picking his spots inside and outside.
And Texas has run 78 plays for 465 yards, 232 rushing, 233 passing. There's your balance.
And Mac might get his wish. 250, 250. It's a little bit here to go still.
Houston's been held to 45 plays, 147 yards. Third and 5 here from the 18. Sims got decked as Jeffrey, the intended receiver.
And really the first poor ball that Chris Sims has thrown. It just came out of his hand and went down to the feet of Jeffries. Never had a chance to make the grab. Well, maybe he was hit before we threw it. I really couldn't tell.
See, Chris, he wanted to go for it again. And,
well, he had a blitz. He had the corner coming down from the near side. That's a hot read, obviously, the cornerback playing, coming into the backfield. Sims read it pretty well and threw it where he's supposed to, just an errant throw.
Bangham hit a 44-yarder earlier. This one from 35. And Dusty gets the good snap. Trahan with the hold, and it is good. So Texas gets its first points of the second half with 6:01 remaining in the football game. And it makes it 34-11. Well, we have seen some offense tonight. We've also seen some defense and some big hits. Let's take a look at some of them that we've had here this evening. Benson got clotheslined there. That was Brock Edwards with a hit on Bell. Take a bow, Brock.
I'm just sitting here watching this stuff and not just reacting or saying anything, because it's just fun to watch those plays. When you make a big hit on the football field, it's fun for you, it's fun for your teammates. And, you know, that's just kind of competitive nature here in college football. And these Cougars, they've been game here. They've brought a little bit themselves. It's not been all one-sided here in the hitting and the physical side of it. I think that Dana Dimble is going to be pleased with the effort of his players here as far as how they competed here. Although the scoreboard doesn't indicate that, but they seem to have done pretty well on the physical side.
By the way, we mentioned Kansas State. They did take care of USC. So 23rd ranked K-State wins 27-20 over Southern Cal, the number 11 team today. So Big 12 finally getting a win over a ranked team, which has been a problem here in the pre-conference games. The kickoff down by Middleton. They'll bring it out to the 20-yard line. The other, just be glad for a win if you're a fan of any team, because Florida, you know, Miami made them look normal. And they go to Knoxville and beat Tennessee today, 30-13. So the number 4 Vols take a tumble. And Notre Dame, 21-17 over Michigan State.
Tyrone Willingham doing something right up there for the Irish.
Got it going. Maybe the most exciting game today did involve the Big 12, where North Carolina State beat Texas Tech 51-48 in overtime, and Tech getting 28 points in the fourth quarter to come back in that game and had a field goal attempt that could have won it in regulation. They lose an OT. Colorado over UCLA, 31-17. First to 10, the look in, and it's intercepted. That is Huff. He'll take it to the house. No flags here. Texas another 6. Michael Huff, 27 yards in the touch.
Good job of coverage on the outside. Nick Getty throws his ball behind the receiver. Michael Huff does a nice job of hanging in there, and the ball pops up, and he makes a play on it. And Getty's going to look out to his right side and throw the ball. Not a bad pass, but a little behind, and you see Cedric Huff coming through and pulling it down and taking it to the house for a score. These Longhorns, Bill, have... We've got a celebration penalty here. They've got a habit of scoring on defense here. When those things happen, good things happen for your football team. Those are hard to overcome.
Editorial comment. Take that celebration penalty and stuff it. You tell kids to play hard, play with emotion, get after it, support your teammates. A guy makes a big play. People run on the field, have a little fun, and here come the flags. End of editorial comment. So it becomes a field goal-like attempt for the point after for Mangum from 35 yards out. No problem for Dusty as he hits it, and Texas gets the field goal and then the interception return and makes it 41-11.
Well, Michael Hunt does a nice job of breaking up on the ball and just taking it away from the receiver. The ball's behind. It's a fun play for a cornerback.
And correct that on Mangum, not with a point after, but McFadden. Matt McFadden getting the opportunity to get some kicking in this one.
Other fans tune in to News 8 Austin for live coverage of Mac Brown's weekly press conference. That's every Monday at 11 o'clock in the morning.
So with 5:48 remaining, Texas up 41-11. Young and old are enjoying it here in Austin. As the Horns rolling by 30 over the Houston Cougars. And Texas will kick it off again. McGee sets up, paces it off.
They've been shooting that cannon off a little bit. We got some smoke on the field.
Yeah. Some of that still might be from the afterburners on Selvin Young's return that didn't count. He showed something. Long kick and Middleton. Bell will bring it out, and he is dunked inside the 15. That was Middleton as Harris making the tackle. Rufus, freshman from LaPorte. Let's go down to sideline man. Working two games in one day, Jim Knox.
No problem, Bill. You know, I look here on the sidelines and look at Roy Williams walk back and forth. Nice win for the Longhorns, but you really have to feel for that young man. Great time he had in the offseason. He removed those bone chips for the ankle. Daryl Drake, Longhorns wide receiver coach, said he was 75% last year because of the sore ankle. He came into this year 100%, and what happens tonight? Looks like he hurts the hamstring. We're going to have to see what happens after the game, the severity of this hamstring injury, but you really have to feel for Roy Williams. A big win for the Longhorns tonight, but it could be a costly one, guys.
Now, Williams last year, certainly not at full speed, 67 receptions for 836 yards, and just a terrific start this year. Well, and there you see Johnson being helped off. So the injuries have mounted a little bit in this game tonight, and Mac Brown saying, well, thank goodness I did hold Vasher and Tubbs out.
Well, you don't want to lose too many of them, that's for sure. You want to have your full complement of players available to you to play this these football games, especially when it comes down to conference play and the big games that they've got ahead of them.
Yeah, first league game, of course, will be Oklahoma State. And the Cowboys are a dangerous team at times. Griffin made the tackle there on Reynolds. As Oklahoma State, you look beyond just the final score against UCLA last week, they did a lot of positive things against that team, and then tonight they were hammering on SMU. You get into league play, anything can happen. And particularly, anything before Oklahoma and Texas play, you can't help but look ahead if you're a player to that game. Second and four for the Cougars. Balling at the line that time, no gain. Houston will be off next week and then play at TCU. They've got three of their next four on the road. Meanwhile, Texas at Tulane as Chance Mock loosens up on the sideline.
Says, I want a chance, no pun intended.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, he's ready to go. He's been warming up a little bit on the sideline. Okay, though, under 5 minutes to go and get him in the ball game.
Here's Eddie firing again, and hit is Bell, lost the football, and incomplete. for Babers. Nice coverage there.
And it was good close on the ball, good contact there with Bell knocking the ball out. Back to our conversation about Chance Mock. This might be the, you know, a little bit of a criticism here, because you got to get your quarterback in there, get some quality snaps. You know, a lot of coaches will use, when they have a young quarterback, they'll use a situation where you'll get your quarterback in there to design time, perhaps in the second quarter when the game is competitive, and you have a chance to play. And we asked Mac Brown that question this week, and his response to us was, he says, well, we've made a decision that we don't want any question marks whatsoever about our quarterback situation, and that's what they're going to go with. Chris Sims is their guy, and they're just going to pick their spots when they're going to put Chance Mock in the game.
And the return game, again, big for Texas, as Pearson showing his stuff here on the return, and Texas will have great field position. Yeah, Mac Brown saying that it is Chris Sims' team for the first time, truly his team. We want to establish that, take care of first things first, and then get Mock the playing time that obviously he needs so he can be ready in case something would happen. Flag on the play, going to bring it back.
Illegal block in the back. On a receiving team, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
Now a couple of returns brought back this ball game by the Longhorns because of penalties. Obviously the long one to Selvin Young, the kick return. A couple times here on punts as well.
So Chance Mock comes out and gets his first opportunity tonight. Sophomore from the Woodlands. 0-2 in the passing game, has run a couple of times, got sacked in that UNT game. He just had no opportunity when he came on in relief of Sims in that game. First to 10 at the 42. Let's see how he fares tonight. Hands off to Selvin Young. Loss on the play. Stopped at the Texas 40.
Pretty interesting. His first play out of the box in this ball game, he has to come to the line of scrimmage and check.
Yeah.
Had a check out of a play that they had called. And the Cougars brought nine players to the line of scrimmage. Matched up outside. They had nine guys around the perimeter, and he checks to the draw.
Chad Davis making the tackle. The second down and 12 after the loss of two. The ball at the 40-yard line. Shanahan comes wide left. Mock rolls out to the near side. Pumping, gonna keep it. Dives across the 45 to the 47-yard line, and Greg Holt makes the tackle.
Didn't look like a whole lot, but really was a pretty good play by the quarterback. Nothing was there. The Cougars did a good job defensively. They took away the receivers, and Chance Mock did exactly what he needed to do and turn it up, get a few yards, bring up a third manageable situation, third and five.
Got some other players that haven't gotten as much playing time. Young is the running back. Robert Timmons, who caught a nice pass earlier, is in the lineup. He's in the slot on the right, and then Jeffrey outside of him. Shanahan on the near side on a third and five. Mock fires this one to Jeffrey and got the first down near the 46-yard line of Houston. It's a good zip on that pass.
Chance Mock from the Woodlands, Texas. High school ball outside of the Houston area. Does a good job delivering that ball to Jeffrey. Got a pretty good arm. Big, strong kid.
3,024 yards and 20 touchdowns senior year. Got all the All-State and All-American honors. Now an opportunity here, 2:18 to go. See if he can drive Texas in for another score. First and 10 at the 46 of the Cougs. Williams was able to spin off one tackler, but not the second. And Ivan hit for a loss of the play back at the 50 as he's brought down, and it'll make it second and 14. Delkin with the stop. And Texas needs 27 more yards to hit that 500-yard mark, and that is heard Max say a goal for his squad. Second and 14, ball at midfield. Shanahan. Picked up four or five on the reception. Cola was there.
A little three-step drop here. Spin back to the outside. Hit Shanahan. Get a few more yards. Brings up third and 10.
Texas, talking about 500 yards. We mentioned the Carolina game, 569. Last year, had 534 against Houston, 606 against Kansas last year, and also 592 against Washington in the bowl game. Third and 10, and time called. So 44 seconds remaining. Texas will talk it over here. And this is kind of what the situation we were talking about earlier, that, yeah, the victory's in hand, but you're trying to develop a player and some players around Chance Mott so that if they are thrown into the heat of the fire in the future, they're ready to handle it.
Well, Chance Mott is 2 for 2. You get a chance to watch Chris Sims tonight. Had an excellent night, 20 for 30. A couple of touchdowns. He did have the one interception, but overall, I think he played very well. Cedric Benson, 37 carries, 160 yards. Take a look at the balance here, 233 yards rushing the ball, and the passing yardage, pretty good complement here. And if you get that kind of a balance, it's going to be tough to stop these Longhorns.
Well, as Mock gets some words of advice, let's take a look at what Chris Sims has done tonight. Good, solid, and very strong early.
Yeah, Roy Williams catching the ball and taking one in for an early score. And Sloan Thomas showing his athleticism. He's going to catch a... That's the interception. They run back.
But you're not going to blame him on that one.
No, he can't do that, but overall, Chris Sims delivers the ball real well. He throws a good tight ball, and he makes good decisions. That's the most important thing. He wants to make the decisions right this year, and Chance Mott's having a chance to go around and throw the ball around a little bit.
He misses on the third and 10, and Texas... As Chris Sims gets some congratulations, 20 of 30 for 233 yards. Clock stops on that incompletion. Texas will kick it away here. Bell will be back on his own 10 for Houston. And Texas, Justin Smith getting a punting opportunity here. Just does get it off. Got a great roll. It hit about the 25 and rolls inside the 10-yard line. And they say, hey, pin him deep. He'll say, that's what I did, coach. We first hit it, everybody kind of gave a groan. And Mac Brown looks on with Houston to get the ball back. And 26 seconds to go.
Kind of a workmanlike game here for Mac Brown and his troops tonight, Bill. Throwing the ball, running the ball. We talked about at the outset here that they want to establish the running game much like they did last week against North Carolina. There's no doubt that they did that here. Cedric Benson had a terrific night. I think the offensive line showed once again that it has the ability to open some holes and enough space for Cedric Benson to get through there. Cedric, I think, has turned into kind of more of a power slasher type back. He's not the speed back to the outside. He's a between the tackle, off tackle type back. And, give him an opportunity to run through there time after time again, and he's going to do good things with it. 37 carries tonight for that young man. That's quite a bit of work.
That ought to wrap it up here. Inside 10 seconds, and Texas will maintain its unbeaten mark at 3-0. And the third-ranked Longhorns of Mack Brown extend their home winning streak to 15 and their non-conference winning streak to 19. As Dana Dimmel sees his Cougs fall to 2-2, but still showing a little spark in the second half after they were really throttled in the first. As they slowed Texas down, and they also showed they had the ability to get the ball in the end zone themselves. Benson the big night as Cedric 37 for 160, as Gary mentioned, and the Longhorns win it here tonight, 41-11 over the Houston Cougars.
Sloan Thomas receiving the football, six receptions for 87 yards and the one touchdown. Did a nice job coming out and establishing himself again in this passing game for the Longhorns. Kind of been missing the first couple of games, only one reception. But overall, talk about a Bill. The Longhorns spread the ball around offensively. Seven receivers caught passes tonight. We had seven players carry balls for the Longhorns also. So a lot of balance, running the football and passing it.
And Texas wins its seventh straight in the series with Houston. And this, at least for the time being, concludes the series. They're no longer, of course, in the same league. And Texas with a 16-7-2 edge, as there are no future games scheduled between these two. And Texas shows its dominance here, winning the last seven. The big question of the night is that guy right there. When will he exchange those blue jeans for football pants again?
Well, hopefully it's soon for the Longhorns. I know that young man should do everything he can to get back on the field. Excellent player. He needs to be out there for this team to be competitive and have a chance to run for that Big 12 championship and possibly even a national championship. It'd be tough to do it without him, Bill.
Yeah, it will be. Texas fans celebrate here, though. The Longhorns in front of another sellout crowd of over 80,000. And Texas making it 3-0. They got 14-0 real quick in the first period, and then waited until 1:42 in the half to score again. And they got 17 points in that last 1:42. A scoreless third quarter. Houston opened the fourth quarter with a touchdown and a two-point conversion, and then the field goal from Mangum, and then Huff's 27-yard interception return as Texas ends up a 41-11 victor. Let's go down to Jim Knox with head coach Mack Brown.
All right, thank you very much, Bill. Mack, you got to be extremely pleased. You talk about that even 500 total yards in offense. You guys right now, 233 yards on the ground, 242 through the air. Those aren't complete numbers, but we're close. That was almost 500.
Well, Jim, it was. We're really excited about the win. Houston's a much improved team from last year, and that was obvious by the 2-1 coming in. It wasn't the same third quarter that we had against North Texas because we moved the ball. We just had the costly turnovers, or we could have gotten Chance Mock some more reps, and that's what I wanted really in the early, late third and early fourth quarter. But great win for our guys. They played really hard. We got to come back and get ready to do it again next week. 15 and straight at home, which is a great credit to our fans. Our fans are unbelievable. In fact, they're still here. It's amazing to me that you're talking about staying late and being loud. They did it tonight.
Something else unbelievable is the performance by Cedric Benson, a career-high 37 yards, also scored a touchdown. Cedric Benson, really, it seemed like he got stronger. He got stronger as the game goes on.
Well, Jim, that's the way Cedric was in high school, and that's what we want to be. We want to be a team that can dominate the fourth quarter and be physical and beat the other team down in the fourth quarter. We did it last week against North Carolina. We did it again tonight.
Pleased about that defense. A lot of turnovers they created. Also got one in the end zone.
Well, it creating turnovers, let them have the one where they earned it with a young quarterback coming in, throwing the ball well. But it's amazing to me that we played as well as we did tonight without Marcus Tubbs and without Nathan Vasher. So that's a credit to our recruiting and our depth.
All right, Matt, congratulations again on the big win. Good luck next week against Tulane, another old school of yours.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right, Bill, the story here, complete domination by the Longhorns as they knock off the Houston Cougars 41-3.
Thank you very much, Jim. You take a breather. You deserve it too, my man. As Texas shut down Houston to just 152 yards of offense for the Cougars tonight. The final 41-11, we're back to wrap it up in just a moment. Welcome back. Yeah, a clear night and a clear-cut victory for Texas. 41-11 over the Houston Cougars. Bill Land, Gary Reese, and Jim Knox to wrap it up with you. Mission accomplished, I guess, the main thing for this 3-0 third-ranked Longhorn team.
Well, 3-0 is where they wanted to be. They did a nice job against the Houston Cougars tonight. Next week, they're going to go down to Tulane, Mack's old stomping grounds. Once again, a second team on the schedule that he's going to be facing. And everything really starts, though, Bill, October 5th. When they get on Big 12 schedule, they'll have Oklahoma State. And that's when things really start for real in the conference as far as things go, as far as winning the Big 12, winning the Big 12 South, perhaps even birth of the national championship. If they win out, there's every reason to believe that if they continue to take care of business, everyone's looking at that October 12th date when they have the Sooners. So if they take care of business till then, and the Sooners do, it's going to be one heck of a football game then.
Well, the coaches tell you, just win one game a week. That's all we ask. And Texas is taking care of that part here today. For Gary Reasons, Jim Knox, and our entire crew, this is Bill Land saying so long from Austin. Once again, our final score, the Texas Longhorns 41, the Cougars of the University of Houston 11. You've been watching coverage of the University of Texas on pay-per-view, produced by Fox Sports Net. So long, everybody.
to Texas.